is a spectacular night in the Valley of the Sun as we welcome you to Glendale, Arizona, as the BCS Bowl Bash continues on Fox in this sensational first-year venue. Boise State tonight steps onto the national stage, playing the role of David, trying to take down Goliath. Oklahoma, after all, is the winningest college football program in the nation since World War II, and they are the heavy favorite in this Tostitos Fiesta Bowl game. The Broncos' journey to this night started with the leap to Division 1A in 1996, but for the Dean of Boise State football, Lyle Smith, a winning tradition started in 1946 under his leadership. One can only imagine, after 20 straight winning seasons and later the athletic director, at now 90 years young, what Coach Smith must be feeling as his beloved Broncos become the first school ever to win a junior college championship, a Division I AA championship, and now play in a BCS game. Here come the WAC champion, Boise State University Broncos. Boise State may be small, but not without talent. The young man to watch tonight, the electrifying sophomore tailback Ian Johnson. He led the nation in scoring and touchdowns. His head coach, Chris Petersen, is standing by with our fourth man in the broadcast booth, Chris Myers.
Tom, and coach, your team, America's underdog, the little guy. Do you feel like you're playing for more than just Boise State here?
Yeah, we're playing for a lot of things. We're playing for the city of Boise, our university, the state of Idaho. And anybody else out there that thinks they might not have a chance, we're playing for everybody.
Undefeated, but you said you hadn't seen anybody as big and as fast as Oklahoma. What's your approach?
Yeah, they are. They're an excellent football team. They got great tradition and history. We're just going to play hard. We're going to leave it all out here on the field tonight.
Thanks, Coach. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you, too. Thank you.
Tom?
Thank you very much, Chris. And while Boise State wears the color blue, Oklahoma is blue, as in the blue blood crown of college football. 7 national championships, 40 conference titles. Wearing the crimson and cream out of the Big 12 Conference, the Oklahoma Sooners. For the first time in nearly 3 months, All-American running back Adrian Peterson will take the field after breaking his collarbone. Is tonight his final game at Oklahoma. For head coach Bob Stoops, what a masterful job with this young OU team. They come into this Tostitos National Champion Fiesta Bowl game having won 8 consecutive games. And a pleasant good evening to you. Happy New Year to you and yours. Alongside the coach, Barry Alvarez and Charles Davis, I'm Tom Brenneman. Welcome to college football here on Fox. Coach, one very simple question everybody wants to know. Can the little dog, Boise State, run with the big dog, Oklahoma?
Well, to run with the big dog, Boise State's going to have to answer 3 questions. Number one, are they physical enough to stand in there and play toe-to-toe with Oklahoma? Secondly, are they fast enough to play at the speed they're going to see from Oklahoma? And thirdly, can they do it for 4 quarters?
Well, we'll find out over the next 4 hours. Certainly a rather odd position, Charles, if you're Oklahoma. I mean, let's be honest about it. Everybody might be rooting for the underdog, but in Oklahoma and the rest of the country, many believe this is a game they should blow Boise State out of here.
And that's what the Sooner Nation truly believes. A they also are saying to the kids, you better not lose to Boise State. That would be embarrassing. So within the confines of the locker room, Bob Stoops has had to do a real job with his team and convince them, you don't have to worry about the outside forces. Let's worry about ourselves. We're the Big 12 Conference champions. We are, as you said, the blue bloods of college football. And lastly, they have no intention of being Max Bear to Boise State's James J. Braddock, the original Cinderella story.
This is fun stuff. I mean, let's be honest about it. Everybody wants to know, can Boise State, only the second non-BCS conference school, Utah did it 2 years ago, and beat up on a down Pitt team, but can Boise State hang with Oklahoma here tonight? They're jam-packed. They've added an additional 12,000 seats in this brand spanking new facility in Glendale, Arizona, from what they normally seat for an NFL game. Of course, this is the home to the Arizona Cardinals football team. And we send it downstairs to the coin toss tonight. William Lamagne, our referee tonight, the officiating crew out of the Big Ten Conference.
Captains, it's an honor to be here. Please introduce yourselves. The coin with the Tostitos is heads. The backside with the team logo is tails. I need your options now. Tails is the call. Natalie? It's come up tails. Boise State, you've won the toss. Boise State's won the toss, deferred to the second half.
We are ready for college football. The BCS Bash begins shortly here on Fox. Boise State University to take on the Oklahoma Sooners. The kickoff is next. You're watching college football on Fox.
Maybe the biggest game, you know, for quite a while after this.
You know, everyone wants to see how the underdogs going to do it. No one really expected Boise State to make it this far, and I don't think many people outside the state of Idaho expect us to even compete with Oklahoma, but we're going to go out there. We've been practicing hard during this bowl practice, and we've been running hard, lifting hard, and we'll be ready to go.
We had a chance to get to Boise, Idaho last week, and they are ready to play. Fox Sports welcomes you to the Tostitos Bowl Bash. Tonight, the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl from Glendale, Arizona. Boise State University against the Oklahoma Sooners. Boise State winning the toss, deferring to the second half. Number 3, Reggie Smith. Number 9, Joaquin Iglesias. Way back, line drive kick. This will be the sophomore Iglesias across the 15, out to the 20, and is tackled out near the 27-yard line. A 25-yard return for the sophomore wide receiver. Up front for Oklahoma, very, very young. They start 3 sophomores, a true freshman, Trent Williams. They think he has a chance to be one of the all-time greats at Oklahoma. Adrian Peterson back for the first time since breaking his collarbone against Iowa State. Brody Eldridge is a tight end, but he'll work out of the backfield. And their quarterback, an amazing story. Paul Thompson, a backup quarterback his first 2 years. And here is Peterson. And he is tripped up behind the line of scrimmage and lunges ahead for a gain of 2. The defense for the WAC champion, Boise State Broncos, Andrew Browning, a walk-on, led him with 8 sacks. Corey Hall and Colt Brooks, both born and raised in Idaho, joined in the linebacking corps by David Shields in the secondary. Very good corners. The freshman Wilson, along with Orlando Scandrick, and lots of experience in the safety spot with Gerald Alexander and Marty Tadman. A reverse. And this is Peterson, and he's out to the 39-yard line. Good enough for a first down after a gain of nine.
I think we'll see tonight Bob Stoops wants to get the ball in Adrian Peterson's hands. It's been a long time since he's been hit. He has practiced, but he has not had collisions. He wants to get him into the game and get into the game quickly.
Yeah, and they want to make sure that he's got ball security early. Oftentimes when you haven't played in a while, some of the good techniques slip for you. They want to make sure Adrian Peterson is tight in that regard.
Peterson, that sensational freshman year when he ran for nearly 2,000 yards, finished second in the Heisman balloting. Not much room this time as he is met by the free safety, Gerald Alexander. Well, you know the adrenaline is running like electricity through the veins of both of these teams coming into the game. Is there anything as far as importance is concerned with being able to calm that for either team?
I think Chris Petersen had to address his team and not being too cranked up, too excited for the game. Just play your game. The emotion's going to take over for itself, but don't be too emotional. Control it.
Already three carries for Adrian Peterson. A second down and eight. Quick throw by Thompson, and it's behind the intended target, Manuel Johnson. That is an incomplete pass. Third down and eight upcoming. Here are tonight's Dodge keys to the game. And Coach, we'll start with you.
We'll start with Boise State has to tackle well. They can't let Adrian Peterson into the back end and have the safeties make the plays.
They also need to have a 3-2-1 launch. They've got to take their big shots when they can. And we'll touch on Oklahoma's after this play.
Paul Thompson looking on the sideline. Still looking over that way. Play clock down to five. They just do get it off. Good protection for Thompson. And it was tipped at the line of scrimmage and nearly intercepted by Hall. So how about the opening stand after a first down from Oklahoma by this Boise State University defense?
Well, it's exactly what Boise State needed. Coming out of the gate early, coming out strong on defense. Adrian Peterson didn't gash them for a big play. They stopped them and forced a punt. We saw a little bit of the emotion come into the game. Manuel Johnson with a big drop early. That could have been a first down for Oklahoma.
That should give them a lot of confidence after that first series.
Michael Cohen to punt, Marty Tadman. Back at his own 15, races up to make the catch, and he is leveled by DJ Wolf on special teams. 34-yard punt, 3-yard return. Let's get back to those Dodge keys to the game and address the Oklahoma Sooners.
Yeah, when we talk about, Coach talked about tackling well for Boise, 3-2-1 launch, go for the big plays. Oklahoma, don't give David the stone in a David and Goliath matchup. Don't give David the shot at you. And then communicate on defense, because we'll see a lot of shifts, a lot of motions, a lot of different sets and personnel from Boise State early. Oklahoma can't be confused. They have to be able to play against all of that and still be aggressive on defense.
That Oklahoma defensive front jam-packed at the line of scrimmage. Jared Zabransky, a very good runner. And he tucks it underneath his arm and carries out to the 34-yard line. A pickup of five by Zabransky, a three-year starter, a 32-5 record. He is starting his 38th consecutive game. The 32 wins more than any quarterback in college football the last three seasons.
You'll see a lot of different personnel, groupings, formations, shifts. We need good communication from the Oklahoma side. Boise State is looking for an advantage when they make these shifts.
First carry for Ian Johnson, and he's out to the 37-yard line. Going to bring up third down and two up front for Boise State. They believe Ryan Clady could be starting at left tackle for just about any school in college football. He is a monster out at left tackle. Ian Johnson ran for better than 1,600 yards. He is a dynamic back, and they have three outstanding wide receivers in Jared Rabb, Legadu Nunne, and Dryzen James, who's from right here in Phoenix. And we talked about Zabransky, a great sophomore year, a down junior year, and has had a dynamite senior year.
Well, they run right out of him on third and short.
They do. And they have the first down out to the 40-yard line. For those that believe Boise State, oh, they're another school out of the whack that throws the ball 40 or 50 times a game, don't be fooled. They average more than 2-1 run to pass as far as yardage is concerned.
That's why I thought that was significant on that play, guys, because Boise State, many people think they're just going to try and trick you and fool you. They like to run at people. That will give them a lot of confidence picking up that first down.
Bransky, good protection, and he's looking down the sideline and overthrows his intended target, Legadu Nunne. Take a look at Oklahoma defensively, really struggled the first three games and then turned things around in a hurry after the controversial loss to Oregon. Thibodeau and Burdine, a pair of seniors at defensive end. Rufus Alexander, the Big 12 Conference Defensive Player of the Year. And the primary changes came in the secondary after that loss to Oregon, where they gave up over 500 yards. Some big hitters in that secondary, led by the sophomore Reggie Smith. Bransky looking around, dumps it off to Ian Johnson, and he is tackled immediately. They'll spot it at the 44-yard line. Coverage and tackle by Zach Latimer.
One of the big question marks and the biggest surprises for Boise State this year was the offensive line. They've started out very strong in this game. You don't see anyone running free in the offense or the defensive front for Oklahoma. They're covering everyone up.
Did not expect them to be intimidated coming into this game. Thus far, they have definitely not been.
Third down at five, and here come the Sooners. They pick up the blitz. In, out, back into the hands of the tight end, Derek Schumann. And that is a catch, and it appears to be good enough for a first down.
I think you gave him the spot,
yes,
across the 50.
Because of the bobble, I thought that he had a first down for sure when the ball first hit his hand. See Schumann right there? But on the bobble, now he's going to move backwards. And there's Nick Harris cleaning things up at the end. But it looks like they've got a good spot and a first down for Boise State.
Yeah.
And that's what Bob Stoops is arguing about right now.
Bob Stoops would like that to be reviewed.
Movement everywhere.
Look at this. That's offensive lineman down here at the bottom of the screen.
Yeah, we're going to take a look. We're going to review that spot.
See, and this is unfortunate for Boise State, not just in reviewing the spot, but they came right back with a trick play and a trick formation.
We have a coach's challenge on the previous play on the forward progress spot for the first down.
So as they take a look after the challenge by Bob Stoops, we will step aside back to Glendale in a moment.
Great challenge.
Replay reviewable plays in college football. Every play subject to review by the booth official. And each coach has one challenge. If the play is upheld, you lose a timeout.
Following the review, the play stands as called. First down, Boise State. Oklahoma is charged a team timeout and has used their coach's challenge.
Bob Stoops must wonder, is he ever going to get a break from an official? Of course, you go back to that controversial loss at
Oregon game. But look where he has possession, right there. And then when he's tackled and moved backwards by the safety, Nick Harris, that's the spot Oklahoma wants. But forward progress gave them the first down. The challenge actually helped Oklahoma because Boise State came out with a wild formation. Maybe Oklahoma wasn't ready to adjust to it, so the challenge actually took the place of the play being run.
Drive started at Boise State's 29-yard line. It's first and 10 from the Oklahoma 49. Play action, and Zabransky looking for it all. Wide open in the end zone. Touchdown, Drizin James. And the first stone fired by David hits Goliath right in the chest.
This is part of the launchers that we talked about. Remember the keys, 3-2-1 launch. Get your big plays early if you're Boise State. Came out with a play action pass. Drizin James with a double move. Beats the Oklahoma defense for the initial score of the night.
Anthony Montgomery, the senior place kicker, on for the point after. And how about that? We ask the question, can the little dog run with the big dog? Well, right now, the little dog has a 7-0 lead. A 49-yard touchdown throw from Jared Zabransky to Drizin James, who play high school football right here in Phoenix. 7-0, Broncos in front. A very impressive opening drive spanning 71 yards. And the left-footed kicker, Montgomery, puts foot on leather, and this will be Iglesias from the 9. And nowhere to go. Nowhere. Austin Smith on the tackle for more on Jared Zabransky. Let's send it downstairs to Chris Myers.
Tom, Jared Zabransky's a changed man. Not shy about talking about going to a psychologist back in the spring. He said he had anxiety problems, and the guy helped him, broke him down to deprogram bad plays, negative thoughts, slowly build up positive things that happened. He said he not only noticed a change in his own life and on the field, but he said his teammates around him started responding to him differently, believing in him and trusting Jared Zabransky.
Chris, thank you very much. So Oklahoma begins its second offensive series from its own 11-yard line. Thompson play action. Under heavy pressure, the ball is loose. And it looks like Boise State has it. The Broncos have recovered. Mike T. Williams stripped it. And he recovered.
He's their best pass rusher. Watch him coming from your right. Just runs over Joe John Finley, pushes him back into Paul Thompson, strips the ball, and recovers it. He's not a starter anymore because they said he's not consistent enough. But when it's time to rush the passer, number 93 will be on the field.
Look who's right in front of him. Corey Hall is standing there, really pulled him up, made him pull up, and let Williams strip the football.
I say they go after it right now. Momentum's all on their side. Take a shot at the end zone first play.
And look at the top of your screen. Wide receiver in isolation. They're going to hand it to Ian Johnson. And he's inside the 5, down to the 2-yard line.
If you're Bob Stoops right now, you're thinking, I've got to settle my football team down. Let's not panic. Let's not get out of control. Let's play. Let's get back into some type of a rhythm here. Settle your offense down so when they come back out on the field.
You hear it all the time in basketball. Weather the early storm. You knew Boise would come right at them. And Boise would like to punch this in right now, obviously, with the run game.
Three tight ends in the game. They hand it to Johnson into the end zone.
Wow.
I'm not sure those are the words of Bob Stoops.
Now that, I tell you what now, they responded to that. I thought we'd see an Oklahoma defense come out there and bow up. I didn't see it. That was pretty easy.
What I liked about Boise State on that series was the mindset. Everyone thinks we're the little guy, that we can't run the ball against the bigger guy. We just ran right over you on two plays and went to the end zone. Mentally, that's huge for Boise State.
Two touchdowns for the Broncos, spanning 1 minute and 38 seconds. Goodness gracious, this is Boise State University Bronco football. They lead 14-0. 14-0, Boise State in front. That one bouncing into the hands of Smith, and again, great kick. Off coverage by Boise State, just a 7-yard return. Ia Follow, a walk-on, and a special teams captain for Boise State. And certainly that brings a smile to the face of the legendary Lyle Smith. Boy, did we have a wonderful visit with him in Boise, Idaho last week.
The man in the blue fedora who put Boise State on the map starting his Boise Junior College when they won the Junior Rose Bowl under his tutelage.
And 20 straight winning seasons under Coach Smith, who later became athletic director. And he is a fit 90 years young. Here's Adrian Peterson, and he is chopped down after a gain of maybe two by David Shields. On offense, what are the Sooners all about? Well, you know about Adrian Peterson. Only played this season in six games and still rushed for nearly 1,000 yards. The quarterback, Paul Thompson, a wide receiver last year, and became the quarterback when preseason practice began. And his favorite target, the sophomore sensation Malcolm Kelly, who has 62 receptions to lead the Sooners. Thompson dumps it off to Peterson. He breaks a tackle and then brings it out close to a first down. We'll see depending on the spot.
I expect Oklahoma in this series because I think early in the game they were trying to establish a rhythm for Paul Thompson as a thrower, as well as using Adrian Peterson as a decoy. I don't think there'll be much decoy now. He's been off for a while. He'll have the fresh legs, his conditioning. They'll check that as they go along, but he's going to carry it. He's going to catch it out of the backfield. I expect number 28 to touch it often on this drive for Oklahoma.
Thompson is a streak thrower, and Heupel told me before the game he wanted to get him into a rhythm. He wanted to get some type of a rhythm early in the game with Thompson.
Play action to Peterson, and Thompson looking for a receiver. He'll carry the football, good enough for a first down, all the way out to the 43-yard line. A 16-yard gain for Thompson. It's really an amazing story, becoming the quarterback again on August the 2nd, one day before preseason drills began. He was a starter in the first game at quarterback last year and then was benched. But when Rhett Bomar was thrown off the team the day before practice began, Bob Stoops came to Thompson and said, "Do you want to do it?" It was reported that he took a night to decide. Bob Stoops told us it took him an hour. He talked to his mom and dad and said, "I'm your man." Alan Patrick, as the play is blown dead. Patrick coming into the game for the first time, replacing Peterson.
False start, 72 offense, 5-yard penalty, still first down.
Our dramatic overhead shots of tonight's Tostitos Fiesta Bowl provided by the DLP Ultimate Picture Cam. DLP is the official HD TV of the BCS on Fox. DLP, it's amazing, it's the mirrors.
Coach, as you mentioned, Josh Heupel, the quarterback coach, wanted to get Paul Thompson into a rhythm early. That hasn't happened so far, but I think his last two plays have been his best. An easy throw to Adrian Peterson, and the last one checked out of the pass and ran the ball for positive yardage. That'll help him get comfortable.
This is Alan Patrick, and he is hammered at the line of scrimmage by the WAC Defensive Player of the Year, Corey Hall. Well, for those of you just tuning in and wondering, how big is Oklahoma winning? Well, guess what? They ain't. It is 14-0 Boise State. A 49-yard touchdown throw to Dryzen James. And then after the fumble by Thompson, back-to-back running plays, and Ian Johnson danced into the end zone. 14-0 Broncos in front. They scored two touchdowns within a minute and 38 seconds. Second and 14. They fake it to Peterson. And throw, and the catch is made by Iglesias at the Broncos 48-yard line. He appears to be 2 yards shy of the first down.
And as he rolled out, my first thought was hit the short receiver in the route because I thought that Iglesias would be covered downfield, and he was. Watch the route. They're going to end up putting two receivers out this way. Paul Thompson looking, the short guy's wide open. He takes a chance downfield, and Iglesias does make the catch.
I can tell you, Kyle Wilson sat all over that ball. He made the break for the interception, and he was right there, but an excellent throw. He drilled it in there.
Third down and a yard. And they pitch it to Peterson. Very, very close. It looked like that final lunge forward was good enough for a first down, and it is.
I'm impressed with Boise State's defense. Every route that has been thrown, they've had very tight coverage in the back end. Paul Thompson has had to bring the ball down. When the ball is pitched or handed off, you have a defense that's running to the ball. You don't see anyone on the ground. You see a lot of people around the football.
Well, they held seven opponents to 14 points or less this season. And against the run, they had the eighth best defense in college football. Inside handoff to Patrick. And he is leveled at the 41-yard line again by Corey Hall. Boy, we will call Hall's name time after time after time all night tonight.
Let's take a look at the all-whack player number 25, Corey Hall, skating. See him right there, inside out. Perfect positioning for a linebacker. And Coach, what I liked about it was the defensive line covered for him. They took up all the gaps. That meant no blocker got downfield to Corey Hall, so he could run free to the ball and make the hit.
And he exploded when he got there.
Yes, he did.
He's a football player. Loves to play the game. He's the leader of this squad.
Second down and six. Play fake to Patrick. Thompson looks down the middle of the field, and it's underthrown to Kelly. And who came down with the ball? Incomplete. Marty Tadman, Orlando Scandrick, right there with Kelly. But if that ball is thrown to the near side, this is six.
Exactly. This ball thrown, if it's thrown over here, meaning then Malcolm Kelly could run under the football. You nailed it right from the start, Tom. Underthrown. If he throws it out there, that's six. That's a lost opportunity for the Sooners.
Third down and six. Thompson was in the shotgun formation. Again, now peeking over to the Oklahoma sideline.
Thompson's getting his signals from the sideline and making a call according to the defense.
Play clock at one. They just got it off. Thompson caught by Iglesias. First down, Oklahoma to the 22.
Let's take a look at, you see Thompson over the football, up under center, and then he backs off. If you notice, he's looking to the sideline. They're getting a good look at the Boise State secondary and what alignment they're in. They're signaling the offensive play, and he's audibling it.
Yeah, really what they're doing. See, Malcolm Kelly looking to the sideline. He's checking his wristband on his pants to get the play call because the booth is really giving the call down to the sideline once they've seen the defense.
Three tight ends. They hand it to Petersen. Steps over a couple of tackles, and he's down to the 15. Tackled there by Marty Tadman, the senior from Mission Viejo, California, after a gain of seven. Well, on defense for the Broncos, they are led in D's by their senior linebacker, Corey Hall, the WAC Defensive Player of the Year, a four-year starter, first team all WAC, three straight years. They get pressure up front from the walk-on, Andrew Browning, who has eight sacks. And in the secondary, Tadman, a ball hawker supreme, 10 career interceptions. 11th play of the drive, Alan Patrick down to the 10. And that will be good enough for an OU first down.
This run game is exactly what Oklahoma needed on this drive to settle themselves down. They took two major blows with the 14 points, the big plays coming right at them. They needed something to get themselves reestablished and kind of get back on their feet. And for Oklahoma, it's running the football.
I think one thing we want to take a look at, let's watch when Adrian Peterson's running the football, if he breaks the front seven. How many times do the safeties have to make tackles? The last two times, they had to.
Last two runs, Adrian Petersen and Alan Patrick have finished the runs impressively, and they're very physical in how they run the ball.
This is Alan Patrick. And he picks up three down to the 8-yard line. Alan Patrick from Conway, South Carolina, was a All-state running back and defensive back in high school, went to junior college as a defensive back, and that's how Oklahoma recruited him. But after all the injuries last year, he went back to running back, and this year replaced Adrian Petersen when he got hurt and ran for 700 yards. In four of his five starts, ran for over 100 yards.
And he's Adrian Peterson's roommate.
Let's not forget, Oklahoma rushed for more yards when Alan Patrick was the tailback.
He actually got more carries during that time frame.
Second down and seven. Thompson to throw to the end zone. Flag comes down. That'll be whistled against Kyle Wilson, the redshirt freshman trying to stay with Malcolm Kelly.
Big size disparity there. Malcolm Kelly, 6'4", almost 220 pounds. Kyle Wilson, 5'10", 186. You know Oklahoma likes that matchup, giving Kelly a chance to be physical and running his routes.
I'd say one thing to take a look at. That's the second time we've seen Kyle.
Pass interference, defense, number 22. By rule, the ball's placed at the 2-yard line. Automatic, first down.
Kyle Wilson has had very tight coverage. Let's look down the road. Let's take a look and watch for some double moves. If he's going to play that tight on the receivers, you have to give him a stop and go. You have to give him an out and up. Give him double moves. Go for the bomb if he's going to try to play that tight.
And Malcolm Kelly wearing the latest in fashion apparel, number 22, in Boise State white.
Adrian Peterson in the I formation, trying to get to the end zone for the first time since breaking his collarbone. And Gerald Alexander says, not this time.
When you can catch a big back such as an Adrian Peterson before he gets his shoulders square to the line of scrimmage, that's when you have your best chance to tackle him. He never got a chance to turn upfield. See how he's running laterally? Gerald Alexander cleans up on that play. If he gets a chance to turn his shoulders and get downhill, that's when he's difficult to handle.
Marty Tapman did a nice job as a safety to get up and bounce it and make it go east and west instead of north and south, Charles.
This will be the final play, more than likely, of this opening quarter. Thompson to the end zone. Touchdown, Oklahoma. Manuel Johnson, his third receiving touchdown of the year. And the Sooners on the board.
I believe they came right back at Kyle Wilson, guys. After the pass interference, they gave him one play off and said, okay, let's see where his confidence is right now. We'll run another receiver at him. Give it a go. Turned out to be a nice call by the Oklahoma sideline.
It's a very settling drive for the Sooners to take the ball down the field, get into some type of a rhythm.
Give your defense a chance to regroup a little bit on the sideline, too. They've had a chance to get off their feet.
Garrett Hartley on for the point after. And it is good. So the Sooners, after falling behind 14-0, take 13 plays to go 82 yards, capped off by the touchdown pass to Manuel Johnson. 14-7, Boise State. Dale, Arizona. Touchdown reception by Manuel Johnson. Coming from Paul Thompson, and the Sooners have cut the Boise State lead in half. Boise State to get the football for the third time in the game. Their first two possessions culminating in touchdowns. This is Rashawn Scott from his own end zone. Great coverage as he tackled at the 18. Let's go downstairs and check in with Chris Myers.
Tom, Coach Peterson of Boise State, last words he told his team when they hit the field: being here is not good enough. What will your legacy be? Up 14-0, it was Bob Stoops' turn over here on the Oklahoma bench, calling his team, saying there's a storm out there. We have to control in here what we can. Line coach James Patton saying, we can wear these guys down. Let's put a drive together. It's exactly what they did.
Well, they start the play clock in college football after the ball is placed down and ready for play. So the first quarter has come to an end at the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl. We ask the question, can the little dog run with a big dog? They're at the quarter pole, and it's 14-7 Boise State. We're back after a word from your local Fox station. Oklahoma at the end of the opening quarter. Now the senior three-year starter, Jared Zabransky, brings his team to the line of scrimmage. Their third possession will start from their own 18. Money in motion, and they set up the screen. Dumped off to Johnson and read beautifully by the Oklahoma defense. That's Lindy Holmes, a sophomore corner out of Dallas, Texas. Holmes, a wide receiver last season, and then in the spring football at Oklahoma, moved to defensive back.
I think this is a really important series for Oklahoma defensively. They've had a chance to rest and relax, watch the offense go to work. And if I'm Boise State, I continue to use my shifts and my motions to try and make them less aggressive. From Oklahoma, now's the time to get aggressive and attack Boise State.
Got to look at Brent Venables, the associate head coach and defensive coordinator for the Sooners. Here comes a blitz. They pick it up. Zabransky fires to Nunne to the 35. And he's out to the 36. They'll move the chains. Well, we wondered early on, Coach Alvarez, could Boise State handle what has become very much a blitzing Oklahoma defense? So far, so good.
Again, look at the protection, the excellent job that the offensive line and Johnson does, picking up a blitzer, giving Zabransky time to deliver. That's an Oklahoma defense that ever since the Oregon State or the Oregon game has come on and played super.
Sooners with 9 sacks in the last 3 games and a big hole for Ian Johnson. And the sophomore out of San Dimas, California, who rushed for better than 1,600 yards this season, has a gain of 16. Boy, he is some kind of player, and what a great kid.
Look at the gap. See the zone blocking, pushing everyone to the left. Now he's got the gap straight upfield, and with his vision, able to step outside and get even more yardage. Like the way the line blocked down to the left, opened the hole to the right for Ian Johnson.
It's a power play. Brad Lau, the fullback, kicking out the outside linebacker.
Ball at the Oklahoma 48. And they hand it to Johnson, and not much room this time. The first man there, C.J. Ayu, the senior from Highland, Utah. His uncle, Junior Ayu, back in 1972, playing for Arizona State in the very first Fiesta Bowl, was the defensive MVP of that game.
And his dad played in the Fiesta Bowl also with BYU, a reserve running back. So the Ayus love to come to Phoenix.
They got a few of those Fiesta Bowl watches.
They played a Fiesta Bowl, the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl.
Tight end Derek Schumann split wide to the right, and Zabransky will dump it off to Vinny Peretta. And he slips out of the tackle of Lindy Holmes and then stepped out of bounds at the 45-yard line. Peretta's developed into a multifaceted weapon at both wide receiver and running back.
I like the way Boise State has come out. I was a little concerned after watching some practice of all the contact they had. Chris Petersen was trying to get that team ready to match the physical ability that he was going to see at Oklahoma. And I tell you, he has them ready.
Yeah, we wondered if maybe they hit too much, maybe took some legs. Thus far, the answer has been, it's been answered. They're ready to play.
Need not worry.
No.
Third down and 7.
Looks like Oklahoma wants to come after him.
Zabransky fires high and through the hands of Marcus Walker, the junior Oklahoma quarterback.
Jumped just a little bit too soon and couldn't stay in the air. Marcus Walker, number 24, saw the pass and it continued to sail. If he had timed his jump a little bit better, that was an easy pick for Oklahoma.
It's a big series for the Oklahoma defense. They gave up a couple first downs, but
getting settled. You know, I like Boise State still staying aggressive with their motions and their shifts and still running the offense that they came here to run. But Oklahoma seems to be settling in a little bit now.
Kyle Stringer on the punt, angling toward the sideline, and that's where Reggie Smith will signal for the fair catch, and Oklahoma will get it at the 15-yard line after a 30-yard punt. 14-7, Boise State at the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl. We're back in a moment. The Tostitos game summary. Oklahoma dominating in time of possession. The Broncos leading in total yards, and the Broncos lead on the scoreboard 14-7. A big turnover by the quarterback Paul Thompson led Boise State to an easy second score.
sometimes just like in baseball, outfielder Marcus Walker saying, I couldn't see it in the lights, the glare of the lights. That's how he missed the interception on third down that led to the punt.
Starting from their own 15, the play fake to Petersen. Thompson rolls right, has an open receiver. Throw on the money, and the catch is made by Manuel Johnson. That'll be another first down. Just short.
We talked earlier about Paul Thompson getting into a rhythm. They wanted to establish him as a thrower. The last drive helped do that because the run game became a little more prevalent, allowed him to make better, easier throws. And you notice on the rollouts, even though it's cutting the field kind of down into a third, it's an easier throw for him. He's got a receiver out there. He puts it on the money. And they get a chance to almost move the chains.
Call it second down and a foot. And Thompson to throw. Good enough for a first down. Out to the 34-yard line. Catch made by Dane Zaslaw. He's only touched the ball six times all year.
Let's take a look at that last possession. Two runs and a touchdown by Thompson.
One run we didn't see in there was a run by Paul Thompson darting up in the pocket, gaining about 13 yards, help open things up.
That was an 82-yard drive, 13 plays, took 7 minutes off the clock. That shows you the confidence on that staff, or the confidence that that staff can exude and give this team composure to answer a 14-point deficit.
They had to add a little bit of time to the game clock. That's what Bill LaMonnier was talking about.
There you see the numbers on Thompson, who threw for the fifth most touchdowns in a season in OU football history. Of course, for many years, all they did was run the wishbone. Petersen carries across the 40 to the 41-yard line. Really, the rushing numbers a bit on the misleading side. You talked about the 13-yard run by Paul Thompson. Thus far, Petersen is averaging less than 3 yards per carry. Patrick, 4 carries, 12 yards.
The one good thing I am seeing from Oklahoma, I don't know if you're seeing the same thing or not, Coach, is they're starting to finish these runs off, because now I'm seeing them become a little more physical downfield when they get to the second and third level, and they're starting to really initiate the contact with the tackle.
I tell you what I'm seeing some seams in the offensive line. The offensive line creating some holes.
Play action again into the far side. The catch is made by rarely used wide receiver Quentin Cheney. And the first down to the Broncos 48-yard line, a gain of 11.
You know, when you look at things from Boise State's perspective, they want to stay aggressive offensively. But Oklahoma's now answered after the early storm that was generated by Boise State's offense, defense, and special teams in covering. Boise State's got to stay with it now, because Oklahoma's coming back at them. They've got to stay with it.
Boise's doing a nice job. They're giving nothing big, making them earn everything they get.
Part of their defensive game plan.
Thompson to throw down the middle of the field, and overthrows. The flag comes in. That was an uncatchable ball, and then contact made by the cornerback Orlando Scandrick on Quentin Cheney.
So many times you see a defensive back panic with the ball in the air. He was in great shape. It's not a well-thrown football. He panicked and went after the receiver.
Pass interference, defense, number 8, 15-yard penalty. Automatic.
And again, to repeat, in the college game, it's 15 yards from the spot.
15 yards for the spot if it's longer than a 15-yard penalty.
Yep.
Anything up to that, it's a spot foul. But you're exactly right, Coach. He panicked because he doesn't play the ball. He played the receiver.
Exactly.
He ran
right
to where Quentin Cheney was. Instead of going to where the football was, he might have had a chance to go after the ball.
And Quentin Cheney,
he's caught two balls all year.
One pass coming into this game. He just caught his second a moment ago, and they were looking for him to go into the end zone.
Hey, Quentin Cheney's just saying, hey, I'm part of the game plan now. Put me in, Coach. I'm ready to play.
Hand off to Alan Patrick. Bottled up at the line of scrimmage. Led by Mike G. Williams. They have a Mike G. Williams, who's a senior out of Lethbridge, Canada, and a Mike T. Williams, a sophomore out of Sacramento, California.
Yeah, the difference between the two, Mike G. Williams is more of the run guy. He comes in, he's a little more consistent. Mike T. Williams, as we saw earlier, a terrific pass rusher. He forced the fumble from Paul Thompson earlier in the game.
Quick snap on a second and 10. Thompson looking to the end zone. Ball's underthrown, and it's intercepted by Ted. The second turnover of the game by Oklahoma. Again, the open receiver, Iglesias, underthrown. Tadman went and got it. Just a spectacular venue here in Glendale, Arizona. A sellout crowd, and of course, a week from tonight, we will play the BCS Tostitos National Championship game between the Ohio State Buckeyes and the Florida Gators. And we'll have it for you right here on Fox.
They won't have to change colors much here. The color's pretty similar for the next two teams coming into play.
Well, after the turnover by Oklahoma, Boise State starts this drive from its own 20. Ian Johnson looking for room to run and nothing there. A gain of one.
Earlier this year, Oklahoma played against Nebraska in the Big 12 championship game. And what they saw from Nebraska is similar to what we're seeing tonight from Boise State. A lot of motions, a lot of shifts, different formations, personnel. But when you talk with the Oklahoma coaches, they said the Nebraska guys got away from that as the game went on. I expect Boise State to continue to do that throughout the ball game, wanting to try and find a little bit of an edge and keep Oklahoma from being as aggressive as they normally are in defense.
That's part of their package, and they won't go away from it, Charles.
Bransky looking for his tight end Schumann, covered beautifully by Lundy Holmes, and it's out to the 23-yard line. So third and long, upcoming for Boise State. We'll call it third and seven.
You know, as we started this game, one of the keys to the game that we brought out was don't give them the stone.
Right.
Oklahoma can't turn the football over. They've given the ball back twice today.
Justin Wilcox, a defensive coordinator from Boise State, told us we have a mantra. If we get two turnovers, we're in the ball game. If we get three, we win it. They've got two already tonight.
Third down and seven for the Broncos. They need to get to the 30. Blitz coming. Zabransky dancing around, fires, and was a catch made by James? No. And James can argue.
Nice job by Zabransky. Showed some excellent mobility in the pocket. Pressure on. He stepped up in the pocket.
Yeah, a good call, an excellent call by the officials, because he tried to get his arms underneath, but watch the ball hit the green turf as he gets his hands down. He did not have his hands far enough underneath to cradle it off the ground.
Well, Boise State taking its time to get into punt formation so their coaches upstairs can have a look.
Interesting to me so far, the biggest plays Boise State has had in the pass game have come against Oklahoma's blitzes. Versus their regular zone looks, they've been able to throw underneath, but Oklahoma's run those plays down.
The punt by Kyle Stringer. And this is Reggie Smith from the 27. Smith cuts it back to the inside and close to midfield. He's tackled at the 49-yard line. Spectacular athlete Reggie Smith is at the 13-yard return. Oklahoma in business. The University of Iowa finalist for the Pontiac game-changing performance of the year. The Hawkeyes have already won a $5,000 scholarship from Pontiac for this defensive stand against Syracuse.
Two wideouts, they send a man in motion, they give it to Shara, and he's held, he's thrown back, game over!
What do you see?
The Hawkeyes, a goal line stand like you'll never see again!
Vote now at Pontiac.com/NCAA to help decide the winner. The $100,000 Pontiac game-changing performance of the year, which will be announced at the Tostitos BCS National Championship game here on Fox 1 week from tonight.
We got Alan Patrick and Adrian Peterson in the game now.
And they give it to Patrick, who's inside the 40. Down the sideline, back to the inside, all the way to the 22 is Alan Patrick.
The top of the game, we talked about having erasers, erase mistakes because of tackling. Watch Alan Patrick, a huge hole, but then he makes the first guy miss right there. That was number 22, Kyle Wilson. And look who is downfield helping the block, helping assist with the blocking. Number 28, Adrian Peterson.
With Peterson in motion, faking the reverse play, Mike T. Williams had to sit outside, creating that seam.
30-yard run by Patrick, who goes to the sideline in favor of Adrian Peterson. And really pretty quiet thus far for Peterson. That's nine carries for less than 30 yards.
See, I think here what's happening with Oklahoma is with Boise State, they're swarming Peterson in the run game, which you would expect because when he's on the field, he'll attract all the attention. But I think these are the runs that will pay dividends later on because I think they're really close in this run game to popping Adrian Peterson. I'm starting to see the line move a little bit more as we continue to go in this game.
Second down and seven, Peterson. Down to the 15-yard line. It'll be a couple of yards shy of the first down, tackled by Nick Schleckaway.
That's the thing that I see, Charles. I see offense. I see some seams. I see Peterson just a hair away from high-stepping through some trash, getting into the secondary. But I see some seams being created as this game goes along. And as the offense stays on the field, that offensive line from Oklahoma can wear down a defense.
All right, on a third down and three. You've gotten in trouble in the passing game, or you're running on third down.
Well, you got two choices here. You put him on the edge and throw it, or you tell him you have two runs at 3 yards.
Four down territory, two runs.
Well, they pitch it to Patrick, and they're going to have to make a decision because he appears to be a yard shy of the first down. All right, you going or kicking?
I'm going right now if I'm Oklahoma. It's only a seven-point game. The last couple times we've had a little trouble, you know, one time throwing an interception. I'm going. I think it was four down territory to begin with.
Yeah, he picked up a half yard. It's fourth and two. If it's fourth and one, I think you go ahead and go for the fourth and go for it on fourth and one.
Is that a full two?
Looks like a full two. It's
All right.
Full two. Go ahead and take the points.
That's why you've won three Rose Bowls, and that's why I'm just sitting up here announcing ball games.
Well,
you know?
He's sitting up here now.
I was waiting to see that spot.
31-yard field goal try by Garrett Hartley out of the hold of Hayes McEachern. And the kick is good. So rather than go on fourth down and two, Bob Stoops will take the points. 5:38 to play until halftime. Oklahoma within four.
You know, we got a ton of guys, walk-on type guys, guys that didn't really get any offers anywhere else. And, you know, I think that's kind of what our program's all about.
Football's not all about size and strength. It's about heart and desire and being able to get things done. And, I mean, Boise State's always been able to recognize that, hey, just because you don't look like a football player doesn't mean you're not a great football player.
Certainly the Oklahoma Sooners finding that out through nearly quarter and a little more than a quarter and a half here at the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl. 14-10 Boise State with 5:38 to play until halftime. Quentin Jones a couple of yards into his own end zone, and he is buried at the 15-yard line by Curtis Lofton. Let's check in once again with Chris Meyer.
On the Boise State sideline, Tom, and underdogs of a feather must flock together. You remember the Cinderella story in the NCAA basketball tournament. George Mason going to their Final Four against the mighty powerhouse schools. They took out an ad in the Idaho newspaper this week congratulating Boise State on the unbeaten season and wishing them good luck in this game on this big stage, showing their support. Coach Peterson said later in the year, if we have it in our budget, we'll return the favor. But just don't tell us when it's midnight.
Well, by playing in this game, Chris, their budget has changed dramatically. After they split up all the money with their conference and the other non-BCS conference schools, that one nearly intercepted. Oh, goodness, Nick Harris. Had an eye on the end zone and apparently not an eye on the football.
What a hybrid guy. Coach, I mean, when you talk about a hybrid, a linebacker, strong safety type, and I know the Oklahoma staff told you this week that this guy would be a factor.
He said he's starting to figure it out. He's a guy that they can use on the blitz. He can be in coverage. He can play linebacker. You like him on the field. This is a big series for both
for both sides of the football.
But Boise State
wants to reestablish some kind of offense. Oklahoma's trying to get field position.
And get the ball back before halftime.
That's right, field position and the ball.
Flags come down, there was early movement. Nowhere to go for Elon Johnson. Boise. Offsides will go against Oklahoma.
Yeah, they're hoping they caught them in the neutral zone and got the snap in time.
Offside defense, number 99, 5 yard penalty, still second down.
Well, don't forget tomorrow the Tostitos Bowl bash continues with a FedEx Orange Bowl. The Louisville Cardinals taking on the Wake Forest Demon Deacons. Talk about Cinderella teams. What an amazing run for both schools. Our coverage of the FedEx Orange Bowl begins tomorrow, 7:30 Eastern, 4:30 Pacific, in high definition only on Fox. And of course, the night after that, the All-State Sugar Bowl. In 1 week from tonight, the BCS Tostitos National Championship game here on Fox. Szebranski just throws it away.
He took a look. He was ready to turn that ball loose. And Nick Harris is under the throw. He took the throw away from it, had to bring it back.
Coach, they always talk about how many are in the box and count that up, right? Take a look what Oklahoma has right here. Right? All those guys in the box, they've got eight in the box versus three deep coverage. You know, when you're counting that, now they've got all the holes covered, and Jared Szebranski's got to step up and go if he decides he's going to run it.
A big third down for Szebranski and the Broncos. Blitz coming. Szebranski. Down he goes. That's a Big 12 Defensive Player of the Year, Rufus Alexander, a loss of six. Early pressure by Lewis Baker.
Watch coming from the right side of your screen, number 16. There's Baker. He misses. Then he steps up. Then he's missed a second time by number 92, Larry Burdine, before the Big 12 Defensive Player of the Year and All-American linebacker Rufus Alexander wraps him up.
That's team speed on defense. People keeping their feet, staying after the ball. Szebranski doing a good job of moving around, but he just couldn't get away from that speed.
I think he's got to learn to move and go. Take off and sting him downfield. The longer he stays in the pocket, the more guys get after him.
Stringer punts from the goal line and a booming kick all the way back to the 35-yard line. What a great punt that was. 51 yards from the senior out of Humboldt, Texas. Our dramatic overhead shots of tonight's Tostitos Fiesta Bowl provided by the DLP Ultimate Picture Cam. DLP is the official HD TV of the BCS on Fox. DLP, it's amazing. It's the mirrors.
That last series, the last blitz, something sticks in my mind about Oklahoma's defense. When they think they've got the advantage, they tend to come after you. That's what Brent Venables did, and it worked quite well for the OU Sooners.
Quentin Chaney in at wide receiver again. Thompson flushed out of the pocket, and a flag comes down behind the line of scrimmage. Thompson chased out of bounds at the 40, but this one more than likely coming back. Let's send it downstairs to Chris Myers.
Okay. Do you want to come back and finish it with King, who's out on defense?
This will be a hold, it looks like, against Oklahoma. We'll get back to Chris Myers after William Lamagne out of the Big Ten gives us all the particulars.
Holding, 50 on the offense, 10 yards, previous spot, still first down.
Now let's go downstairs to Chris Myers.
Yeah, Tom, Malcolm Kelly, top receiver for the Sooners, has not played in the last two series. Previous to that, he was hit hard, shaken up, had his helmet off. They thought maybe he suffered from a concussion. He shook it off, said I'm okay, but they said you're not going back into the game for right now.
So that's why we're seeing so much of Quentin Chaney. Chris, thank you very much. Thompson throws it back the other way to Joe John Finley. That's like a greased pig. He can't get a hold.
Screen play. Well, you get sprint action away, a tight end screen, which was set up.
They set up quite well, and it's the second time I've seen Oklahoma tonight try and use a misdirection throwback pass. On the last interception Paul Thompson threw down the middle, that's where he wanted to go first, was a misdirection pass. Couldn't get it. Then he tried to throw it late down the middle and underthrew it for the interception. On that one, Joe John, if he catches it, he's got some real estate.
He missed it four times.
Even hit him in the butt.
And he's a former quarterback.
You know, when that ball came and he was looking down the field.
Oh, he was thinking about the turf he was going to eat up.
Second down and 20, blitz coming. Oklahoma picks it up. Throw and catch by Johnson. He gets back to the original line of scrimmage out of the 35-yard line. So third and 10 upcoming for the Sooners. Clock under 3 minutes. Oklahoma has two timeouts remaining. The Broncos have all three of their timeouts. A little surprised they're not taking one here?
I'm really not. The reason why, they've got the lead right now. They want to try and milk this clock down. They'd love to go into the half exactly where they are, not so much thinking about being aggressive on offense here, but make sure they hold them on defense at this point.
I'll tell you what, when they get the ball back with any kind of field position, they're not going to sit on it.
No, not at all. But right now, they're saying, okay, if they've got the ball, right, let's just make sure we hold them. Let's not play for it any other way.
Well, now a timeout is called by the Sooners. So Oklahoma has one timeout left. Third and 10 upcoming. We're back. Day after tomorrow, the All-State Sugar Bowl. The Notre Dame Fighting Irish in the final game for quarterback Brady Quinn taking on the LSU Bengal Tigers. Our coverage of the All-State Sugar Bowl begins Wednesday, 7:30 Eastern, 4:30 Pacific, in high definition only on Fox. Notre Dame has not won a bowl game since 1994. They have lost eight straight, including the blitzing against Ohio State last year.
1994, was that a bowl game in New Orleans? Was that the Sugar Bowl when they beat the University of Florida?
That was
Florida.
It.
Where they broke out the white shirts with the green stripes and the green socks and stunned the Gators.
Third down and 10 from their own 35. Thompson looking for room. Throws incomplete. So Boise State will get the football back right around the 2 minute mark. And again, they have all three timeouts remaining. Oh, there is a late flag on the far side of the field. Boise State saying that is against the Sooners. We'll see.
They sure hope so. They do not want to negate a terrific defensive play by the Boise State Broncos.
This could be a really big penalty. If this is a personal foul, and by Bob Stoops' reaction, he was screaming at Joaquin Iglesias. They might back them up 15, which is better field position for Boise State.
That'll give Boise State excellent field position, and they'll definitely come out winging it.
Decline
and
following
the play, unsportsmanlike conduct, baiting, charged to Boise State, number 8. Personal foul, late hit, number 9, Oklahoma. Those penalties will offset fourth down.
That's Iglesias getting tangled up with Orlando Skendrick.
Well, it took the decision-making process out of Boise State's hands, so they didn't have to worry about it at that point. Let's look at the end of the play. Right here in the middle, number 8. There's Orlando Skendrick woofing at Iglesias, and then number 9, Iglesias actually headbutts him back. He's fortunate that all he got was a personal foul penalty in that situation. I mean, when he initiated that kind of contact, he's lucky that he's still on the field.
Boise State, over the last 7 years, 28 blocked kicks. Very short punt off the foot of Michael Cohen. And the official will spot the ball at the 35-yard line. So with 2:05 to play until halftime and all three timeouts left, Boise State pretty good field position. Not a bad half for Boise State on the defensive side.
Boise State has played excellent defense. You see every gap field. They were concerned about missed tackles. I've seen a couple missed tackles. They've tackled very well because they've swarmed to the football.
And Justin Wilcox, their defense coordinator, asks for erasers all the time. Guys who erase the errors of their teammates. If you have a missed tackle, who's going to be there to pick up for them? We're seeing that already this evening. A number of guys to the ball on every run.
See a couple of takeaways. A sack, Oklahoma, 2 of 5, converting on third down. Ian Johnson takes a handoff and looking for room and There's not any there. All of a sudden, things have gotten pretty quiet for Ian Johnson.
And I think that Boise State is looking at the clock, minute 30 left. They're still up in this ball game. I don't think they want to make a mistake here and give Oklahoma a chance to score going into the locker room. They've done their job.
And now this time they hurry up to the line of scrimmage. And Zabransky with a wide open receiver at the 47-yard line. That's Jeroen Rabb, who's now caught a pass in 26 consecutive games. Good for 18. When they spot the ball, the clock will start again.
We'll give Chris Petersen a lot of credit for he fooled the heck out of me. I thought he tucked his horns in.
As you said it, Charles, I saw him come to the line of scrimmage. They snapped it with 24 seconds on the play clock.
One of the new rules in college football, once they reset the chains, that clock starts back up. It's been a controversial decision.
Timeout, Boise State. First team timeout.
So it's their first timeout. They have two left in this half with 106 remaining until halftime. Coming up, the blockbuster halftime show comes your way here on Fox. Chris Rose, Jimmy Johnson, and Barry Switzer will break down the first half, plus performances from the school bands and the Tostitos Habitat for Humanity. You won't want to miss that. Great stuff.
You know, I've already figured out what my mistake was in my reasoning. You know what it was?
What?
I'm thinking like Boise State's going to come to this game and change their personality from what they've always been, which has been an aggressive go-for-it, go-for-down type team, always keeping the pedal to the metal downfield. I'm thinking they're looking up and saying, hey, we're ahead 14-10. Let's not make a mistake. Wrong. Boy, was I wrong on that one. Boise State continuing to attack.
Well, I think what you saw on the first play was a run. You naturally think they're going to just try to get out of this
especially
half.
Especially when it didn't gain much.
Get out of the half, but all of a sudden they're back to the line of scrimmage, snapping the ball with 24 seconds on the clock and getting it down the field.
We talk about recruiting and where do they find players to come play football at one of the great winning programs in the country, Boise State. 43 of them from California, 20 of them in state, and no other state in the country more than five. In fact, they go north of the border to get four.
You know, it's a great job of evaluating, and it's not five-star recruits that they're getting.
First down at the Sooner 47-yard line. Good protection for Zabransky. And had an open today down at the 25-yard line and missed it.
I'm impressed with the protection. Again, you have a full-out blitz. Everybody is covered up. There's nobody on edges. The offensive line is squared up on every blitzer. Zabransky has a lot of confidence in that protection. He's allowed to get some rhythm in his throw and step into the throw.
I think the best-looking plays they've had throwing the ball downfield have come against the blitz. That's where they've had what appeared to be their best chance for chunks of yardage versus the zone. They've had to throw underneath, and Oklahoma runs those plays down.
Ball start,
66, offense, 5-yard penalty, still second down.
That's Tad Miller from Boise, Idaho, played at Bishop Kelly High School. Well, you look at this offensive line during the season, only allowing a total of 17 sacks, and I know the cynics out there will say, yeah, well, who do they play? Well, the bottom line is, no matter who they played, they only allowed 17 sacks.
Yeah, I don't care if you're doing that against air in practice, you know, and you're just playing two-hand tag in the quarterback. That's impressive.
First down, blitz coming. Zabransky steps up, chase from behind, and he can fly out across the 40 and down to the 36-yard line. It looks like he has enough for a first down. Zabransky runs about a 4.5 40. He can fly.
That's what we've been asking him to do here from the booth, and I know his coaches have wanted him to do that. A 16-yard gain, and what I mean by his coach have wanted to do that, step up, be definite, and run the football downfield against the coverage. That gains them yardage. You don't have to worry about a bad pass.
We talked about him moving the sticks with his feet and not always trying to having to throw the ball down the field.
You'll make the blitzers more hesitant if you step up and sting them by running the ball into the secondary.
Ball down at the 36-yard line after the 16-yard carry by Zabransky. We're under a minute until halftime, and the Broncos have two timeouts left. Far side catch made by Rabb, trying to get out of bounds, and does. down to the 26-yard line, a gain of 9.
Again, good protection on a full blitz, man coverage on the outside, an excellent delivery.
He's not having to worry at all against the blitz. He's able to actually step into his throws. Normally on a blitz, against a blitz, you're not able to get everything on a throw. You're having to move around. He's stepping up and firing.
Got the ball out of bounds. You have one timeout, 47 seconds.
Two timeouts.
And remember, first downs give you mini timeouts because they have to set the chains.
Well, they just made a mistake here.
Substitution, offense, 5-yard penalty.
This is
still second down.
This is one thing that could happen with all the substituting and all the personnel groupings. 12 people in the huddle, when they broke the huddle, it's a penalty.
You got to know your personnel groupings in the game, who's in, who's out. Teams work on it all the time, but in a game like this, sometimes you get emotional. They've got a good drive going. They want to score before the half. Someone probably got a little overzealous and cost them 5 yards.
So now they back them up to the 31-yard line. You get a look at Anthony Montgomery, who's hit on 13 of 14 this year. His long this season is 40 yards. Zabransky steps away from trouble, throws to the far side, and James cuts it back to the inside. Now to the corner of the end zone. Touchdown. Holy mackerel. Drives in James from Phoenix, Arizona's Westview High School. His second touchdown tonight.
Tremendous awareness by Zabransky. That was a throwback. That ball, he sprinted to his right. The ball was to be thrown across the field to his left to the tight end. What tremendous awareness to find an open receiver.
And when James caught the football, were you thinking, get to the sideline, get out of bounds? When he turned inside, I thought he might have made a mistake initially, but he turned it into great profit for the Boise State Broncos.
He smelled that end zone. He saw that orange end zone.
He knew those colors, didn't he? This is what you're talking about, Coach.
Looking to throw back. Keeps his feet, but look at the awareness.
And the arm strength to get it out there that far. And then James breaks the tackle and dives in. And Boise State with the momentum as we head towards the half.
Charles, we're talking about that speed at Oklahoma. Look at this speed.
Starting to wonder as we hear all this talk about speed around the country, who has it, who doesn't. Everyone has it.
Nobody's recruiting slugs.
No, anymore. Those guys don't make it. The other thing is, I'm wondering about the evaluation of this so-called five-star talent or not five-star talent. Boise State may be blue-collar, but they are blue-collar with talent. And I think that gets overlooked sometimes, and we don't give them enough credit for being skillful football players.
I'll tell you what their coaches do. They develop. They're programs that recruit five stars. Everyone knows who they are, but you have programs that recruit players. They talk about walk-ons, great attitude, and you develop them.
So with 33 seconds left in the opening half, a huge touchdown for the Broncos. This is Iglesias, and he's out to the 29-yard line. Boise State starting that last drive at its own 35. They needed a minute and 32 seconds to get into the end zone. Aerial coverage of tonight's Tostitos Fiesta Bowl is brought to you by Budweiser Select.
Look at him going for the pylon. He knows where it is, and he knows the ball breaks the plane, keeps his body in bounds, and gets 6 for Boise State. I'm interested to see what Oklahoma decides to do here with 12 seconds. Run the ball inside, get the heck out of here, and Boise State, watch how they leave the field at the end of this half.
Well, they're going to hand it off, and that will be the final play of the opening half.
Watch Boise State take off out of here.
The Boise State University Broncos have come to the desert, and at halftime, an overwhelming underdog coming into this one against Oklahoma. A 21-10 lead. Stay tuned. A special Tostitos halftime program to see if Fred Banks' dream of home ownership comes true.
The big question, could Boise State hang with OU? In a word,
You bet. Using a little extra effort and a huge first half from quarterback Jared Zebranski to lead the Sooners 21-10. Hi, everybody, and welcome back. I am Chris Rose, joined once again by Barry Switzer and Jimmy Johnson. And, Jimmy, a huge drive at the end of the first half there, engineered by Zebranski for the Broncos.
Well, with Zebranski, with his mobility, you know, he is able to avoid the rush, and he has probably been the most impressive player on the field. And like you say, they deserve to be there. Now, defensively, you look at Boise, and they're playing right into their plan. As far as they've got the two takeaways, they're playing an eight-man front. They're stacking up against the run because they know that Oklahoma needs to have the play-action passes and need to run the ball.
That's exactly right. For Oklahoma to win this football game, they have got to run the football. They've done a pretty good job defensively against Boise State's running game. But for them to win, we can't get in a throwing match. We can't get in the spread offense. We've got to have success. We got to have success because Paul has got to have some success in the running game to be able to play action pass. He underthrew two deep passes, and it could have been different if he launched
a little further. It's going to be a great second half.
Without a doubt, guys. Boise State, a 21-10 lead over Oklahoma. Tom Brenneman alongside the coach, Barry Alvarez and Charles Davis. And, Coach, we begin with you at halftime. If you're Bob Stoops, what are you saying in your locker room?
Well, you're saying we haven't played our best football, and there's a lot of ball to be played yet. So let's just stick with our game plan. But we've got to play better. We've got to play better, but let's not panic.
Charles, on the Boise State side.
Yeah, I think you have to be very clinical in the locker room. You've shown that you can play with Oklahoma, and they believed that before they came into the game, and stay aggressive in your offensive play calling. That's what got you the 21-10 lead.
Boise State will get the football to begin the second half. And this is Rashawn Scott letting it bounce into the end zone, so Boise State will put it in play at the 20. Let's check in downstairs once again with Chris Myers.
Well, I just talked to Bob Stoops, and he was concerned about Malcolm Kelly. Said he had his bell rung early. He hopes to get back into the game at some point. Said they have to run the ball with more authority. On the other sideline, the Boise State team said that they expect the Sooners to pound away, but Coach Petersen said they'll continue to throw even with the lead they have. Tom?
Chris, thank you very much. For that final drive in the opening half, Boise State needing only a minute and 32 seconds to get into the end zone to open up this 11-point spread. Ian Johnson, nowhere to go, a loss of two. Some of the numbers from the opening half. Sooners outran them, and the Broncos outpassed them. Two big turnovers in that first half, one directly leading to a Boise State touchdown.
One you gave up a touchdown, and the other one you gave up potential points. And that's what we talked about, not giving away the football.
And you notice time of possession is heavily in favor of Oklahoma. Sometimes it doesn't mean as much as you think.
Caught a loss of three on first down on the carry by Johnson. So now Zebranski back to throw. And again steps up. Fires, catch made on the far side. And that's a tight end, Derek Schumann. He's out across the 25 to the 27. Third down and four upcoming. The offensive leaders for Boise State. A very impressive opening half by the quarterback, Jared Zebranski. Wasn't in a lot of trouble, but the few times he was in trouble, he stepped away from it and made some big throws.
I'm impressed with his awareness. I'm impressed with his feet and his mobility in the pocket. He's shown a lot of composure.
Most people remember nationally the game against Georgia when he had six turnovers in 2005. He's nothing like that quarterback was that day.
Third down and four. Receiver was covered on that quick slant. And now Zebranski just has to run out of bounds. So three and out on the opening drive of the second half for the Broncos.
Couldn't be a better series for the Oklahoma team as a whole. Yes, the defense went out and did its job, but that's going to give a lift to the whole bench, because you have to know that at halftime, there was some discussion about, hold it a second, these guys are as good as they thought they were. How are we going to handle that? That was a good opening series for OU.
That paint may be peeling a little in that locker room. I have a sense.
Peeling. There's a whole wall or two that needs to be repainted after the halftime for OU.
Well, at least Bob Stoops didn't damage a cane like Barry Alvarez did at halftime of the Rose Bowl about a decade ago. Another booming punt by Kyle Stringer. And Smith evades one tackle and brings it out to the 32-yard line. A 47-yard punt. Stringer's done a nice job in the punting game for the Broncos. Oklahoma gets the ball in a moment. Here's a Nissan strategy shift for the Oklahoma Sooners. A couple of turnovers. One deep in their own territory, which led to an Ian Johnson touchdown. Then with Oklahoma on the move, the poor throw by Johnson, interception by Tadman. Coach Alvarez, what needs to change? Strategy shift time for the Sooners.
Well, we talked about eliminating turnovers. They have to establish a running game. They're close. There are some seams and limit the Broncos' passing game. And I think you'll see much less blitzing because the blitz was not effective.
Not very effective in the opening half was Adrian Peterson. 11 carries, only 35 yards for the All-American out of Palestine, Texas. This is his first game, again a reminder, since October the 14th. He broke his collarbone in the Iowa State game at the end of a 53-yard touchdown run.
And they've got them both in the game now. With that, he's got him in the game with Alan Patrick. Earlier we saw him come around and fake reverse. And here he comes in motion now.
Read beautifully by Orlando Scandrick along with Mike T. Williams.
See, that was the counter to what we saw earlier in the game. They ran fake reverse to Adrian Peterson, gave it inside to Alan Patrick. This time they show the same motion. This time Peterson gets the ball. Watch the play by Orlando Scandrick, number 8, the corner. He read the play, got inside of Quentin Cheney, number 84, so he couldn't block him, and made the tackle. See, they're reading it from the booth. Checking the coverage. Now the call's coming down to change things or go with the play that's being called from the sidelines with Josh Heupel, the quarterback's coach.
That play clock is down to 3. They just do get it off. Thompson being chased by Browning. Just throws it up in the air to Cheney, and it's intercepted by Gerald Alexander. He's across the 35 to the 40. And nearly to midfield, the third Oklahoma turnover.
A poor decision by Paul Thompson, throwing across his body, across the field, nothing on the ball. That's like a jump ball.
Across his body, across the field, and deep down the middle. You talk about the triangle of errors. Paul Thompson made them. And this is so uncharacteristic of him because he's been so error-free all year long. Boise State has the advantage.
So far, the upstart Boise State University Broncos like their time in the desert. They force their third turnover, and now with 11 minutes to play here in the third quarter, Boise State with a football and a 21-10 lead. Ian Johnson crosses midfield to the Sooner 49, shoved out of bounds by Alonzo Dotson and Lundy Holmes.
I thought we might see one down the field on that. Sudden change of possession always is a time you bring a defense back on the field, an excellent time to take a shot.
Sometimes teams call it off after a commercial timeout or a timeout by the other team, thinking, okay, now they might have a chance to get settled. We'll go ahead and run our normal offense. Doesn't mean they might not come right back to it, though, after the first play.
Delay handoff to Johnson. And nowhere to run. Tackled by Calvin Thibodeau, the senior out of Houston, Texas, and a flag comes in late on the far side of the field in the secondary.
I think we're going to have a problem. It's downfield in the secondary for Oklahoma. I don't know if they're going to call it on the defensive back or the receiver for after the play.
Following the play, personal foul, late hit. 91 on the offense, 15-yard penalty. Third down.
Derek Schumann, the tight end, one of their smarter players, an all-whack performer, getting downfield after the whistle and still getting after the defensive back to
Take a look to the left of your screen, right there. There he is. It's Derek Schumann. And he stays with it with Nick Harris and rolls him up after the play is over. And the flag came in from the back judge.
Didn't seem, it looked like a possible leg whip where he kicked his leg
kicked
up.
Him after, yeah, after he rolled him up on the block.
So they back him up 15. And rather than third and 7 for Boise State, it goes to third and 22. They need to get to the Oklahoma 43-yard line to convert.
Haven't seen him run a screen yet or a draw.
Well, there's your draw to Johnson, and he's out across the 40. Boise State forced to punt it away.
They took the safe route right there, just not wanting to throw the ball down the field and force the ball. But it looked like they tried to come out in that series and establish a running game with Johnson.
Yeah, and you know, that tells you the intelligence of Chris Petersen and his staff, understanding when to attack and when to lay back and have a little confidence in the rest of your ball club. Defense has played well this evening.
Stringer, a high snap. Smith, a fair catch. Flag comes in. Oklahoma will start this possession for the time being anyway at the 22, but again, we'll wait on the penalty. Big Ten officiating crew. William Lemonnier, our referee tonight.
Illegal block in the back, number 11. Oh. That's a post-scrimmage kick enforcement. We'll go 10 yards. From the spot of the catch, first down.
Bobby Jack Wright, co-D coordinator, talking to Lendy Holmes.
Here are tonight's Taco Bell impact players of the game. Jared Zabransky has only missed on 6 of his passes thus far as a pair of touchdowns. Paul Thompson, 1 fumble and 2 interceptions.
In a sense, what we're looking at there is positive impact versus negative impact. That's not to criticize Paul Thompson, but he has not been as careful with the football as he has been all year long, which is what made him, what many thought, the MVP of the Big 12 this year.
Well, as the Sooners begin this drive at their own 12, Alan Patrick has come into the game. And he gets a yard, maybe 2. You know, we talked to Bob Stoops at length 3 days ago and said, Adrian Peterson's back. But it's been a long time since he's played, almost 3 months. If for whatever reason he is not having a good game, will you sit him down and get the ball more to Patrick, who's played here down the stretch since Petersen got hurt? He said, we're here to win the game.
He's going to play who's hot. And neither one of them have had much to look at.
Petersen waits it to the outside. And he's out near the 20. A late flag comes in again.
It's been 8 weeks since he's touched the ball. We talked about it earlier. Getting him into a rhythm, getting hit.
So there's going to be a face mask against Boise State.
Incidental face mask. Number 8 on the defense. That 5-yard penalty results first down.
The one thing I saw, I did see flashes early. I thought there were a couple seams where a sharp Adrian Petersen steps over the trash and comes out the back end.
Sometimes I wonder if you overthink it, too, in terms of, you know, Alan Patrick's played well. We've got Petersen back. Let's go between the two of them. Before he got hurt, he would have had all the carries. And what they would have counted on is him popping something late in the ball game. I might think about that strategy with Adrian Petersen.
Peterson is in there, and Thompson to throw on first down, intercepted, and into the end zone goes Marty Tabman. Tabman, his second interception tonight. 12 in his career, that's his second touchdown this season.
Wow, that was an underneath flat coverage.
I mean, it looked like
that wasn't there.
Looked like three deep coverage with a strong safety underneath, and Marty Tadman, he got to the flat, and the ball, he appeared to be the receiver. He was the guy in the area, makes a perfect break, and carries it home.
We better get, the ball looked like the ball may have been tipped. Looked like the ball may have been tipped there.
Two that have been doing it all year long. Corey Hall tipped the pass. Tadman went and got it.
Right there, number 25, Hall. The middle linebacker tips it. Tadman underneath in the coverage. Kind of replaced the blitzing Colt Brooks, number 31. And Boise State.
We've talked about Corey Hall being a football player, always being around the ball. And that's a prime example.
28-10, Boise State in front. Joaquin Iglesias breaks a couple of tackles, still on his feet. Flags littered all over the field. At the 10, at the 20, at the 35. During the regular season, Paul Thompson threw a total of 8 interceptions in 304 attempts. He's thrown 3 interceptions in 16 tries.
On the return, illegal block in the back, 22. Half the distance to the goal, first down.
You know, I always take a look at a team when you see penalties on the kick in the kicking game with clips. When you see motion, you always think lack of concentration, lack of focus.
Right here. To the push in the back by Keenan Clayton, who started the season as their starting strong safety, but lost his job after the first couple of weeks.
Adrian Peterson met at the line of scrimmage by Dennis Ellis.
I know many people are sitting at home because Chris Myers gave us a report about Malcolm Kelly being hurt, the number one receiver for the Sooners. How is that affecting Paul Thompson in the pass game? But what's affecting him more than anything is they're not able to run the football, because Paul Thompson gets his best looks throwing the ball off of play action, off of bootleg, when the run game is operating well. Tonight, because they're not really worried as much about the run game, they're into pass coverage a lot easier.
Of course, in that Big 12 championship game, Kelly had 10 receptions for 142 yards and 2 touchdowns. They're without him tonight. And a slant over the middle, the catch made by Iglesias, first down to the 23, the 14.
The other part of what's happening with Paul Thompson tonight is that he's had open receivers and has underthrown them consistently. He missed an opportunity for a touchdown pass early, and then the other 2 interceptions prior to the last one were underthrown balls where receivers were open, not making good choices at all times, and that's uncharacteristic of Paul Thompson this season.
Still plenty of time for the Sooners to get back into suit.
But they have to be able to run the football. They've got to get into a rhythm doing that also.
Well, they're going to throw it. Thompson steps up. Perfect throw there to Iglesias, who's become his favorite target now with Kelly out of the game. And he's all the way out to midfield.
You know, the one thing Bob Stoops mentioned to us was the tremendous mentality that Paul Thompson has. When he has something go wrong, he won't let it affect him as the game goes on. He'll put it behind him and focus on the next play. And that's very important, particularly in a situation right now.
One other thing to go on to your point, Coach. Last year, he started the season as the starting quarterback. They were beat by a non-BCS team in TCU. He lost his job after that afternoon. Tonight, he can't lose his job. They don't have another option at quarterback behind him.
First down, and they're going to put it up again. And overthrowing Chaney down to the 20-yard line. Chaney, who had one catch the entire season, has been in the game replacing Kelly all night.
As you said earlier, Charles, I think it's going to be very difficult for them to throw every snap and bring this game back. Somewhere along the line, you have to get something in the running game. Plenty of time left on the clock. A lot of time left in this game.
I'm a big believer in team DNA. And it's not the Oklahoma DNA to step back and fire it 50 times in a ball game.
Emmanuel Johnson And a great open field tackle by the redshirt freshman Kyle Wilson from Piscataway, New Jersey. Led that high school to three consecutive state championships. He was the MVP of the New Jersey State Championship game as a junior and a senior. Our overhead shots of a Tostitos Fiesta Bowl provided by the DLP Ultimate Picture Cam. DLP, the official high-def TV of the BCS on Fox. DLP, it's amazing. It's the mirrors. Huge play for Oklahoma, third and five.
Big play. Here they come.
Slant. Misread somewhere. Great coverage by Quentin Jones.
And a great call by Justin Wilcox, defense coordinator, because he changed up the blitz. Most of the blitzing tonight has been by the outside linebacker, number 31, Colt Brooks. This time he exchanged him for Orlando Skandrick, the corner. And he brought the corner from the wide side of the field right into the face of Paul Thompson, so he had to look at the blitzer, and that helped force the incompletion.
The one thing Paul Thompson's going to have to come up with, you have to have an answer for the blitz. They showed that blitz, gave him plenty of time to react. Now you've got to stick that ball in there. You've got to answer it.
Michael Cohen. As Tadman will let it drop. The ball checks up and then hits. Did it hit a Boise State player? If it did, it'll be Oklahoma football. And it is Oklahoma football. The ball came back and hit a Boise State player in the leg.
Communication is the key on those types of plays. When you are the punt returner, you have to make the call. You've got to get everyone away from the football. You've got to send out the signal. There it is, hitting him right there.
He's
right
got
the back of the leg.
He's got to attack that ball, screaming to everyone, whatever their alert is.
Right.
They've got to call the alert and get him away from the football.
Iona Key, backup wide receiver. Hard to blame him there.
No, it's hard.
It's hard to blame. He's blocking. What he needs is to hear the call. Universally, the call's Peter. Peter, 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 get away from the football. Somehow that didn't get relayed enough for him to pick it up. He was just trying to block and help his team.
Big break for Oklahoma. Can they cash in? They need seven.
Has to be. Field goal is not an option for OU here.
Alan Patrick with a carry. He gets down to the 8-yard line. Andrew Browning, the first man to meet it.
I'm impressed. Watch the defensive front of Boise State. There's no movement. They make contact. There's no movement at the line of scrimmage. There's no place for the backs to go. And we've got to get, I would say right here, you've got to get Thompson out on the edge. Give him some type of a run pass option. Open up the game a little bit. Get out on the edge. Give him something to look at. It's not there. Get it down the field. There's nothing inside.
Second and seven. Peterson to the end zone. His first score since breaking his collarbone against Iowa State. Back on October the 14th, and the Sooners are right back in it.
I like to see him. If I'm Bob Stoops, I like what I see on the edge. You want to see him on the edge. You hope that started the fire.
You called it, Coach, about getting them out to the edge, getting to the corner. I was thinking some type of a misdirection. Anything to get them out of the middle because of the way they've stacked things up inside and they're not getting the movement or the push up front. That time they got them on the move, Adrian Peterson got vaulted to the end zone.
Well, now Hartley on for the point after. Trying to make it an 11-point spread. Which he does. For the first real big mistake of the night, Boise State, the punt, getting key in the leg. Oklahoma recovers. Two plays later, Peterson to the end zone.
Better settle in. We better settle in for a good ride, huh?
Buckle up.
Buckle up, folks. Get that seatbelt strapped on.
Quentin Jones out of his own end zone. And brings it out to the 17-yard line. Let's go downstairs and visit with Chris Myers.
And Tom, Adrian Peterson hoping to give the Oklahoma Sooners some life. His father, the last time, his father Nelson, the last time he saw him play was mid-October when he hurt his collarbone. His dad is here tonight after serving 8 years in prison. Adrian said his dad stayed with those father responsibilities, was an important part of him maturing as a young man, and hopes as his dad calls him, AD, nicknamed him all day. It was important for him to play in this game to make a contribution to Oklahoma before deciding whether or not to go pro.
Chris, thank you very much. Szafranski to throw on first down. And he finds Gerard Rapp out of bounds at the 26. You know, you talk about what was supposed to be a day of celebration and then go straight south. Mr. Petersen comes to the game, sees his son play. His son breaks his collarbone. After the game at a family reunion, yeah, Adrian's mother, Bonita, broke her leg playing in a basketball game.
Playing little hoops.
Yeah.
She was schooling everyone. They had like a little family reunion. And she was dropping 30 on him before she turned the ankle.
Oh. And that is a true story. That's not something out of Hollywood. Szafranski stepping away from trouble. And he just flips it.
It's going to be a legal touch.
Of course, this will be an illegal touch. Szafranski's been around a long time. And granted, he's under heavy pressure, but that is a mistake.
Huge.
That's a mistake. You see momentum. And I always talk about momentum in the game. And like a pendulum swinging. The pendulum is at Oklahoma. They have the momentum. Can the defense answer? Szafranski helped him a little bit right here.
He helped him a lot, Coach, because he's out of the pocket. Remember, if you're outside the tackle box, as they call it, you can fling it up into the, you know, the fifth deck. It doesn't matter. There's no intentional grounding. He would have saved a lot of yardage on that play had he done just that. And that's one of the few mistakes we've seen from Jared Szafranski.
That's exactly
he's
right.
Played
Chris
pretty
Petersen
well overall.
Said, didn't want him to play outside of himself. Just wanted him to execute. Try to make something happen
yeah,
there.
Try to do just a little bit too much.
And the guy who caught it, Jordan Daly, he's from here in Phoenix. And, you know, he's coming back home, wants everybody to see him, told he was too small to play at Arizona
exactly.
State.
He'll be talking about that forever. He high-stepped out of there.
You know what he's going to be doing. He's going to get this tape and just keep
rewinding
it.
Illegal touching, number 69 of the offense. That penalty's been declined, result of the play, third down.
You know, you touched on him, Tom, Jaden Daly, the center. At 5'11", 285, was told, as you said, he was too short. You know where his inspiration was to continue to play college football after he sat out for a while? Clayton Adams, the previous center at Boise State, he was also about 5'10", and did an excellent job for them. He's now a grad assistant on the Boise State staff.
Yeah, amazing journey for Daly. Got out of high school, went to work as a bank teller, and then got talked into playing college football at Phoenix College. Boise State came after him. And here he is in a Tostitos Fiesta Bowl on his home turf. They decline the penalty, does Oklahoma, to make it third and seven. Szafranski steps up, throws in and out of the hands of Rabb. That would have been good enough for a first down, and he dropped it.
Earlier in the game, remember Marcus Walker in almost the same type of position, missed an interception for Oklahoma. Gerard Rabb looked like he had the same type of a catch. I don't think he's going to look up and say it was the lights this time. Ball was right in his mitts, and he's not unable to come down with it. Would have been a first down for the Broncos.
They came back with a blitz that time.
Nick Harris, the strong safety, came after him.
Oklahoma figures to be a good field position. Reggie Smith stands at his own 40. Stringer puts a foot on it. This is Smith. Didn't call for a fair catch. Great coverage by Iafalo. Follow all of 165 pounds. A walk-on who's earned a scholarship at Boise State. Big play a short while ago. The punt came back. Hit a Boise State player in the leg. And then on the second play following, Petersen to the end zone to get Oklahoma some momentum.
You saw that 4-3 speed right there.
Yes, you did. And you know what I've noticed? Oklahoma in recent series, Alan Patrick has usually started the series on first down before Petersen comes in.
Thompson lays it off for Petersen.
Great pursuit.
Great job. Along with Orlando Skedrick right there with Petersen.
So they had great leverage when they got outside with Adrian Petersen, and they knew where to spill the play, meaning if I'm going to miss on the tackle, I'm going to push it to a certain area. Colt Brooks pushed it to the proper area and had the help from Orlando Skandrick. Nowhere to run for Adrian Petersen.
Gain of 1 second and nine. We're under 2.5 to play here in the third quarter. And Boise State leading Oklahoma 28-17.
Is Petersen again in motion?
Thompson to throw the football. Wide open. And making the catch, Iglesias. Inside the 30, down to the 28-yard line. A gain of 32.
Hey, that's a terrific catch by Iglesias. You know why? His momentum was totally going to the sideline, and the ball was thrown back inside a little bit. He was able to break it off and secure the catch. Nice job.
Fake to reverse. Held a blitzing corner.
See, we've seen all three plays off of that now. The handoff to Patrick, the handoff on the reverse to Petersen, the fake to both of them, and throw it downfield.
Iglesias, five catches for 104 yards. In the absence of Kelly, Thompson rolls right, and he'll tuck it under his arm. And very close to a first down inside the 20. And here come the Sooners.
Coach, you made the point not too long ago about the composure and the makeup of Paul Thompson. I believe we're seeing that now, considering he's thrown three interceptions tonight and has not played his normal game, but it seems to have shaken it off.
Well, he's got a little rhythm right now. They've got a little something going with this series. He was outside of containment. He has a lot of options. He has an option to take a look downfield. He has three receivers who are covered, but he's out of containment. Now he can do it with his feet. Move the sticks with your feet.
Second down and a yard into the open field is Alan Patrick, and he has a first down inside the 10 all the way down to the 7.
Because of the series you've talked about, Coach, with the misdirection, take a look at the left side of the offensive line for Oklahoma. Watch what they're going to get done, clearing the path here for Alan Patrick. Look at that, Duke Robinson, 72. Chris Messner, 79. Both of them all Big 12 performers pushing down inside and creating the gap for the tailback.
Been a good night for Patrick. Only 10 carries, but 58 yards.
Pretty productive, isn't it?
He'll get it on the play fake. And he's close to the 5. Corey Hall and David Shields converge on the stop.
Again, you can see Two defenders sitting there, shoulder square. There's no extra yardage after contact. That's good fundamental defense. If you turn your shoulders, that back splits it, and he's going to get extra yardage. But you saw the legs churning, but there's no place to go.
The old shoulder to shoulder sometimes works, doesn't it?
It does. Shoulder square.
First-year head coach Chris Petersen, certainly a look of concern. We're under a minute in the third quarter. Oklahoma trailed this game 28-10, and now trying to get it into single digits. Jump ball, and nearly a miraculous catch by Quentin Chaney. Good coverage by Skandrick, but Chaney's alone.
Well, I thought they had him on the run. They're going outside. They got things loosened up inside because of their play selection. The fake reverse, the quarterback on the edge, the stretch play. Then Oklahoma hits one up the middle. We come back, I think they thought they had a mismatch.
I think they did. I was a little bit surprised. I thought they'd run the ball on that play with Petersen, considering the fact that Chaney comes into tonight with one catch on the season.
Thompson in trouble. Down he goes. Boy, you gotta wonder about the play calling by Oklahoma. It's almost as though, and Coach Charles, you fill in the blank here, it's almost as though they're abandoning the running game against Boise State.
They lost confidence in the running game, but they had a little momentum running the ball. I'm surprised that they went away from it. I said that on the last down when they threw the fade.
Yeah, you go back to that call, because now that puts them in third and long situation. So they have to throw the ball again, and Boise State got them with the blitz.
So now Oklahoma will be forced to kick a field goal, but we'll wait on that until the fourth quarter. End of the third. Boise State 28, Oklahoma 17. The Tostitos Bowl Bash on Fox continues after these messages from your local Fox station.
Here in my leg, and they would not walk. Just a dream.
Sentiments. Well, that music, they're out of Austin, Texas. So after the sack of Thompson a moment ago, we make our way to the fourth quarter. This will be a 28-yard field goal try by Garrett Hartley, who's already hit from 31 yards out tonight. He's only missed once all year.
In the back of your mind, you wonder if Bob Stoops thinks about faking one with his reputation.
We'll take the points. Right down the can off the foot of Hartley. The largest Tostitos Fiesta Bowl deficit ever overcome. 14 points. Twice it's happened. Last in 1988, when Florida State roared back to beat Nebraska 31-28. Well, tomorrow the Tostitos Bowl bash continues with the FedEx Orange Bowl. Louisville and Wake Forest try to end their Cinderella seasons with wins. Our coverage of the FedEx Orange Bowl begins tomorrow at 7:30 Eastern, 4:30 Pacific, and high def only on Fox. Matt Baskersian, Pat Hayden, and Terry Donahue on the call. I wonder how Donahue and Hayden are getting along down in Miami. Terry, of course, legendary coach at UCLA, and Pat Hayden, the quarterback at USC.
Well, what Pat Hayden's saying is, we beat UCLA when I was a quarterback. Terry Donahue is saying, well, when I was there, we lost like our first four. We roared back and won that series. So both of them have a lot to claim in that relationship.
Oh, and by the way, Baskersian might be the tiebreaker there. He went to SC.
Oh, well, it's tough. It's a tough boot then for Coach Donahue.
Oh, yeah.
He's a little tilted on him, isn't it?
Gonna look at the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl trophy. 8-point spread with nearly the entire quarter to go. Sean Scott from the goal line, and a good return out to the 28. Well, the lesser-known program against the juggernaut program, the 1991 Fiesta Bowl, Louisville against Alabama. The Cardinals came out firing. Quarterback Browning Nagel hit Latrell Ware. 70-yard touchdown, the route was on. Nagel finished with a Fiesta Bowl record, 451 passing yards. Defense, special teams, amazing for the Cardinals in a 34-7 shellacking. We opened tonight asking, could again David take down Goliath? Ian Johnson into the secondary, out to the 32-yard line. Been a quiet night for Johnson. 13 carries, 43 yards.
It'll be very interesting to see how Boise State offense reacts. They can't tuck their heads. They've got to come out. They've got to make some things happen. The momentum is with Oklahoma right now.
Coming up to line to scrimmage quickly.
Second down, handoff to Johnson. And he breaks it to the outside. And that's good enough for a first down. That is the first down in the second half for the Boise State offense.
We spent time in Boise, Idaho, visiting with this ball club. We've talked with enough people, pro scouts, coaches. What's the one word they use about Ian Johnson most often, besides tough, because he's all of that? Patient. He's a very patient runner. He waits, he reads the blocks, he lets his lineman get out ahead of him, and then when he sees a hole, he bursts through it. We just saw that on that 14-yard game.
How many times have we seen him come out of the pile and come shooting out the back end?
Sometimes you lose sight of him, and then here he comes.
Timeout going to be called by Zabransky. Well, to finish that story about Ian Johnson being tough, broke his ribs, punctured his lung, stayed in the game. Spent 5 nights in a hospital in San Jose. Wednesday night, the Tostitos Bowl bash continues with the All-State Sugar Bowl. Notre Dame taking on LSU. Our coverage of the All-State Sugar Bowl begins Wednesday night, 7:30 Eastern, 4:30 Pacific, in high def only on Fox.
That's going to be a fun one.
Trying to win a bowl game for the first time since 94. LSU on a great run to close out the year.
They're the ones, you know, they got into the BCS, the second team out of the SEC, by how they finished up the season.
Fourth quarter just underway. First down for Boise State. They pitch it to the far side to Johnson, looking for some daylight, and is able to push forward and pick up a gain of 3, maybe 4. Let's send it downstairs once again to Chris Myers.
Well, Todd, you guys were talking about the toughness and patience of Ian Johnson. He's been teased, the story well documented, his mom recommending he crochet, knit caps as a way to relax, which he has done. He says his toughness, you know, his father's a firefighter, and he thinks people that think he got his toughness there, but he said, my mom's a social worker, and if you watch what she does, I get my toughness from her. That's a very difficult job.
They hustle to the line of scrimmage, and the throw is too high for Vinny Perretta.
And it's a lateral. I believe that's a lateral, so they will lose yardage on this play because I saw the linesman immediately stand there and thrust his arm out, you know, away from his body towards the end zone.
Well, they hurried up to the line of scrimmage trying to keep, Oklahoma off balance.
But you can see with all the different formations and shifting on the prior play, Nick Harris got there just before the snap.
Yes.
They had three receivers. They try to out-leverage the defense and get the pitch. He got there. Now they try to do it before Oklahoma could adjust.
Loss of four, third and 13. Szebranski steps up and he can run. But he is hammered to the turf by Rufus Alexander.
That's impressive. Open field tackle. It's like a form tackle.
It's an absolutely perfect tackle, but it brings to mind the scouting report on Jared Szebranski. He's one of the three fastest players on the Boise State team, but he never makes people miss. Straight from the coaching staff, rarely makes people miss. Well, it's hard to make Rufus Alexander miss anyway. That's why he's the Big 12 Defensive Player of the Year.
I was going to say, if there's one cat you want to make miss, it's Rufus Alexander.
That was like a heat-seeking missile right there.
And not many people allow him to miss, that's for sure.
Springer puts a foot on it. And Smith calls for a fair catch all the way back to the four. And Coach Alvarez is gritting his teeth together.
Never,
go ahead, Coach.
Never step back behind the 10-yard line. Ever.
Let him have it. Boise State jumped in front 14-0. 49-yard touchdown to Bryson James after an Oklahoma turnover. Ian Johnson a touchdown. And after building an 18-point lead, a special teams break for Oklahoma. Capped off by an Adrian Peterson touchdown. They've added a field goal since to chop 10 points off what was an 18-point advantage.
You have to think the Boise State defense has been on the field a lot in the second half. Can Oklahoma continue to try and wear them down and have those 3-yard runs become bigger?
Oh, my. Dennis Ellis, say hello to Adrian Peterson.
Not going to wear down anyone like that. Great job by Dennis Ellis, defeating the block by George Duke Robinson. So you want to be a football player? Are you sure? Check this out.
Wow, that's how it's supposed to be done. Defeat the offensive line. It'll look tired and worn out to me.
Coach, that was a training film tackle right there.
Loss of one, second and 11. Thompson out of his own end zone and broken up in the secondary by Alexander. Jarred it loose from Joe John Finley. Well, you can't say enough. Whether they win this game or lose this game, Boise State University is proving to Oklahoma and the rest of the country, for those of us that ask a question, can they run with the big dogs? They are running and perhaps running away from the big dog.
They're setting the pace. They jumped off the porch ahead of the big dog.
I'm going to tell you, they're not backing away from anyone.
No.
And I'm surprised how they've reacted. I'm surprised. It's late. It's middle of the fourth quarter. And we talked about, can they last four quarters? They're pretty fresh to me.
Thompson carries and he's tripped up by David Shields. And Oklahoma will punt out of its own end zone. What a stop by the Broncos. And Bob Stoops is livid.
See, now you go back to the punter, Kyle Stringer, and the great job he's done tonight. He set all of this up with that last tremendous punt, and of course, catching the ball on the 4 or 5 yard line doesn't
help.
But
that
now he's helping change field position. He's tilted it in favor of Boise State.
If you've noticed most of his punts, very high punts, a lot of hang time, all of them near the boundary. They're really pinning the ball in there, so there's really no place to run anyhow. Well, he's done a great job.
Do you go after it right here, or do you want the football?
To get good field position. Looks like they're going after it.
Good punt here by Michael Cohen. This is Chapman from his own 40. Crosses midfield, and he was shellacked by Lewis Baker.
I tell you guys, if you love football, you love what you've just seen. They're hitting on both sides. The game's physical. The game's on the line. You've got two teams that are really competing, and they're getting after it.
Like Barry Alvarez and Charles Davis are banging one another up here in the booth. Let's cool things off a minute. Aerial coverage of tonight's Tostitos Fiesta Bowl from the University of Phoenix Stadium in Glendale, Arizona is brought to you by Budweiser. Brand new facility about 10 miles north of downtown Phoenix, gorgeous. Arizona.
Just gorgeous. Hey, with this field position, why not take a shot? They haven't gotten much done offensively this half. Why not go after it?
We're going to hand it to Ian Johnson, and he breaks through the initial defensive front of Oklahoma and carries it down to the 44-yard line.
You know, in this half, was Boise, before this drive, four possessions. They punted it four times. The points they got, the interception return for a touchdown by Marty Tadman. I'm looking at this field position here and the way Kyle Springer's punting the ball. Even if you get stuffed, you're going to put Oklahoma in the hole. This is why I would go ahead and try and get something big on them right now.
Watch number nine, the top of your screen. They have some plays called for him tonight, though. They're going to hand it to Ian Johnson. And he has perhaps enough yardage inside the 40, needed to get to the 39. Ian Johnson came in second only to Garrett Wolf in yards rushing per game. Been pretty quiet for Johnson, but they're staying with him, and why not? 16 carries, 64 yards. In eight games this season, they gave him the ball 20 or more times. Durable, tough, strong late.
And he loves the bright lights of national television. Their biggest TV games, 715 yards and 14 touchdowns scored this year.
Gonna get it again. Plows ahead inside the 35-yard line. Chris Myers talked a moment ago. What a delightful kid Ian Johnson is. Grew up just outside of Los Angeles in San Dimas, California. Went to Damien High School. Hard to believe in Southern California that some of the quote-unquote big boys didn't come knocking on the door of Ian Johnson.
He didn't have the measurables maybe some of them were looking for, but he talked about it earlier in our ballgame. We had that great sound bite. You know, about measuring heart and understanding that. Well, we're seeing the evidence of it from Ian Johnson, and we've seen it all year long.
You're going to keep seeing him get the ball until he's stopped.
Hard to bring him down. And is that ball loose? On the far side.
Yes, it is.
Oklahoma has recovered. Rufus Alexander stripped it away, and Curtis Lofton covered it up.
It's big players, great players play big in games like this.
They make the plays that you need to give you an opportunity. There's Alexander. 42. See how the ball ripping. He pulled it out before Johnson was down. Lofton alertly jumps on it. Oklahoma in business and now not in the shadow of their own end zone.
Trying to fight for a couple extra yards, finish a run, expose the ball.
That's a strong man, Rufus Alexander.
Yeah, he did a great job digging and digging while also securing the tackle.
So now Oklahoma gets the football back. 8:30 to play here in Glendale at the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl, and the Sooners trail 28-20. Peterson spins out of one tackle and brings it out to the 33. Colt Brooks drags him down, a gain of four.
You can see there's nothing clean inside. And Peterson's fighting, I'm telling you, he's trying to finish every run. But we saw earlier, it's outside is where there's some things loose.
What you're thinking is more stretch,
more stretch
runs,
plays.
Stretch plays on the run.
Plays.
And the stretch play, that long outside handoff, running it to the outside numbers, right? To the outside of your offensive tackles and looking to find the gap and get upfield.
Under eight to go. Oklahoma has all three timeouts remaining. Play action. Peterson pump fake, rolls, and picks up a first down out to the 40. Very nicely done by Thompson.
He took a look. He took a look at
a number of looks.
All of his choices. He made a good decision. There's nothing there. Use your feet. Pull that ball down and run.
So this tells me there was good coverage downfield because he was well protected with plenty of time to throw a ball in rhythm. But because he had nowhere to go with it because of the coverage downfield, he alertly tucked it away at the end of that and ran upfield. Got a nice block from Adrian Peterson on the corner, allowed him to get out of bounds upfield.
Finley in motion. Peterson a carry. Nowhere to go.
I tell you what, these guys up front from Boise State, that defensive front is penetrating so well that there is no room for the running backs right now. Doesn't matter if it's Peterson or Alan Patrick, they are getting upfield and creating havoc.
You'll never see the end of the defense knocked off. You never see a dent in the defense. They're always up the field penetrating and always have the proper leverage. That's what I see. Everyone's fitted in the right gaps with the proper arm free and no place to go.
Down to 7 minutes. A second and 11 for the Sooners. Quick throw to Johnson. And he is tackled good. Open field tackle out of the 45-yard line made by Kyle Wilson. Boy, if he beats Wilson, he's off to the races.
You know, this is an interesting call here, Coach, because earlier in the game, I was talking about four down territory, and then when it came up fourth and two, they ended up punting the football.
You may be at four down territory. You've got 6 minutes left,
yes.
Charles. You've got 6 minutes left. It depends on what you have here. Bobby Stoops is a gambler.
That's what I'm thinking.
Third and four. Long ball and too long. For Quentin Cheney, he had beat the defender. If that ball's on the money, Oklahoma's going for two.
Ball sailed on him a little bit.
And actually, there was there wasn't enough air in this one. To me, it's much more of a flat throw instead of air that gives him a chance to run under it. He threw it flat and long instead of a little bit of loft.
So with 6:10 to play, Bob Stoops has decided, at least for the time being, to punt. But you never know with Bob Stoops.
He's going to put it on his defense.
But if you're Boise State, you play what we call punt safe. You say you're lined up, you're alert for any type of a fake. You don't care about him punting the ball. You just don't want him faking it.
He is going to punt it. Beautiful hang time here. Tadman will let it go and into the end zone. 6:01 to play at the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl. Can Boise State now drive the dagger into the OU defense and put this game away?
Game, Tom Brenneman talked about the big man for the little school at Boise State, Lyle Smith. Now late in the stages of this game, a big upset possibly in the making for the Broncos. So big that the governor who played for Lyle, Butch Otter, sworn in earlier today, took a plane here to the game to be on the sideline and root for the Broncos and hopes, as he called it, the biggest thing to hit Idaho since the potato, that his team could hold on. Tom?
And the son of a potato farmer, Jared Zabransky, who grew up just across the border in Oregon, is trying to lead Boise State to what would be a monumental upset of Oklahoma. But first things first, tackle made by Lundy Holmes on the first down carry by Ian Johnson.
I'll tell you the one thing that Boise State has to watch, and they can do right now. You've got a timeout, Oklahoma, but they've got to milk the 25-second clock. The last series, they were snapping the ball with 15 seconds on the clock. If you manage the clock properly, you've got an 8-point lead. If you manage it properly, snap the ball with less than 5 seconds, you take a series away from your opponent.
I think they also can't get too conservative in what they're doing, too, because I don't think that Oklahoma is going to allow them to just run the clock out. I think we just saw Lindy Holmes coming in from the corner position. They're going to come after him right now. I think they've got to make some plays and get some first downs.
And again, a reminder, our Bowl Bash on Fox continues tomorrow night. Louisville and Wake Forest, two great stories in college football this season in the FedEx Orange Bowl. Coverage begins at 7:30 Eastern 4:30 Pacific, only on Fox.
Tom, earlier we showed those showed the giant killer video of Louisville taking out Alabama here in the Fiesta Bowl. Louisville's no longer that type of a team. They're more of a bully. Wake Forest fits that definition. Wake Forest and Boise State together is a heck of a banquet, isn't it?
It's going to be fun tomorrow night. So keep it right here on Fox. Adrian Peterson, is he down to the final 5.5 minutes of his brilliant Oklahoma career? Boise State trying to give their first-year head coach Chris Petersen a perfect season and a stunning upset in this Tostitos Fiesta Bowl. Can the OU defense stop Sobranski and company? Second down and 10. He will throw it. And backing in to the sideline is the wide receiver, Rab. You scratch your head.
He lost where he was. He didn't realize where he was. Had his back to the boundary. Thought somebody was on his back.
And his off, and the offensive line for Jared Sobranski did another terrific job picking up the blitz. We're down to 3rd and 1. See, if he had field awareness, that's a first down for Boise State and a few more yards. But since he didn't, it now creates a 3rd and 1. But again, the Boise State offensive line has done a great job all night long.
Well, now they snap the ball with 10 on the clock. Sobranski going to roll. How about the call and the first down conversion? Great call, and they find the tight end, Derek Schumann, for a first down.
In the first half, I was wrong about what I thought Boise State would do. I feel like I'm a little bit better rhythm myself this half because they ran up and snapped the ball. Great call, right? But what did I say? They can't go so conservative and just hand it back to Oklahoma. Too much time left on the clock. Run your offense. Run the things that have been successful.
You know, Tom, you say great call. It was great execution. The call, it's always execution.
Well said, Coach. Well said.
You don't execute, everybody goes, what are you, dummy, throwing the ball?
We're at the 5-minute mark, and they'll keep it on the ground to Ian Johnson, and he breaks into the open field. And Johnson out to the 47. A 15-yard run for the sophomore.
Can't say enough about this offensive line.
I mean, look at the holes. Look at the guy. There's Tad Miller, 66, coming around. Daly, 69. On the right side, Cavender, 64. Andrew Woodruff, they nicknamed him Psycho, number 60, chopping big holes in the defensive front of Oklahoma. And look for a lot of blitzing coming from Brett Venables in the Oklahoma defense, so there could still be more big runs there if they pop the first level.
First down, we're down to 4:30 left. Oklahoma with 2 timeouts remaining. Stay on the ground with Johnson. And he picks up a yard. Johnson in, closing in on 100 yards tonight. Now at 95. Our overhead shots of tonight's Tostitos Fiesta Bowl provided by the DLP Ultimate Picture Cam. It's the best camera in football. DLP is the official HD TV of the BCS on Fox. DLP, it's amazing. It's the mirrors, and it doesn't get much better than that.
I'd like to have that at home. Watch the rest of the bowl games.
Well, you own Wisconsin. I'm surprised you don't. And by the way, congratulations of your Badgers and the man you handpicked to take your place, Brett Bielema, who won or lost games. Only one time.
12 wins.
12 wins, joining Larry Coker and Chris Petersen.
Chris Petersen, yeah, he's 12-0 right now.
12 wins this season. So congratulations to the Badgers.
Well, they played great. I talked to Brett afterwards and congratulate him. He said, Coach, we didn't play very well. I said, oh, Brett, you won the game.
Yeah,
don't worry about that.
Get into that.
Go relax. Go have some fun and celebrate. What a great year.
A terrific year, and again, my congratulations also. But as I look at this ball game, the thing that has probably impressed me the most about Boise State and how they've played this game is there has not been a lot of trickery in terms of getting it done. You often think about the David and Goliath games, and you've got to fool them all the time and run reverses and fakes and all this other stuff. They've really gone toe-to-toe all night with Oklahoma and gotten them running their regular offense.
Second down and 9. Oklahoma with 1 timeout remaining.
Got to protect the ball here. Boise State cannot turn over the football in this situation. That's Oklahoma's best hope.
Can you believe this? Oklahoma is calling a timeout. Brent Venables almost looking with a question expression.
Third and final.
That is their final timeout. Can you believe that? goodness. Well, Bob Stoops is really upset on that Oklahoma sideline. They just burned their final timeout. What happened here?
Well, they broke the huddle with 12 players. Bob Stoops is saying that's a penalty. Oklahoma has the wrong personnel grouping in the game, but he saw it with when the 12th guy went off. He wants a penalty.
See, they got one earlier in the ball game, remember? Illegal substitution. They had a 5-yard penalty. He wants another one here in this situation. If in his estimation, the officials missed that one. The officials said it didn't happen.
Been a rough night for the 46-year-old from Youngstown, Ohio. Oklahoma coming in. I mean, he had it ready to play. There's no question. You brought it up earlier, right from the start, Charles. They were not in any way, shape, or form overlooking Boise State. Give the credit to Boise State. They have shown up in the desert to play tonight.
Tell you what, this Cinderella title for all these teams coming out. Utah pounded Pitt in this bowl game a couple of years ago. The Cinderella thing's starting to go the way of the books, isn't it?
Safe handoff. Fake handoff. And Zabransky just going to burn some time. Oklahoma now out of timeout. They can't stop it. All right, now what about on this 3rd-and-9 call?
He's got to throw the football. He's got to throw the football. You've got a punter that's been dropping the ball inside the 10-yard line all day. Oklahoma's going to have to drive the ball 90 yards. You want to throw the football and try to keep the ball. See if you can't move the chains one more time.
And with the punter they have, I would really think hard about trying to get something big on the outside. I know you don't want to hold the ball too long back there, but maybe you take a shot with one of those big receivers outside and really try and make it work here.
Zabransky to throw. Now he'll step up, and he is blocked at the 44-yard line. 25-second play clock has not started yet. And by the time it does so, for whatever reason it's not running right now, we're going to be under 3 minutes in this game.
And the game clock continues to roll. Boise State people, it can't roll fast enough.
Boise's sitting there, Oklahoma saying, why hasn't that clock started?
And it's a great question, isn't it? Because how much time ran off? I'm counting somewhere close 10 to 15 seconds that ran off before the play clock began that Boise State's going to gain, because they won't snap this ball until 2-3 seconds on the clock.
Oklahoma with 2 block kicks this season. 20 under Bob Stoops since he took over. They're not going to get to this one.
They snapped it with 2 on the play clock.
Smith, the fair catch. Well, Oklahoma, the 23-yard line, has 2 minutes and 40 seconds left. Trailing by 8. This Thursday night on Fox, don't miss Till Death, the new hit comedy starring Emmy winner Brad Garrett. Catch an all-new episode Thursday, 8 Eastern, 7 Central, right here on Fox. Here we go.
One thing to keep in mind in the college game is that even without timeout, you can still throw across the middle if you get first down yardage, because the clock stops to reset the chains.
Ball Thompson out of the shotgun. Throw and a catch is made by Cheney out to the 35. The clock will stop until they reset the chains. Gain of 12.
This is where Oklahoma has to huddle. Hustle. Get on the ball. Get ready. When that clock cranks, when the official blows the whistle, you want the ball snapped. You don't want to lose any seconds.
See how well they do with that.
Catch, Manuel Johnson. Out to midfield and crosses midfield to the 47-yard line. Clock continuing to run.
And another first down and a Boise State player. We have 2 players limping for Boise State. One of them being Orlando Scandrick, their best cover guy. That means Austin Smith, number 37, goes into the ball game, and he's cold. Coach, I don't know about you, but I'd find the new guy right away.
That's what I'm saying right now. If you're up in the box for Oklahoma, you're signaling that we got to challenge him right now. We've got to go after the new one.
Kyle Wilson was also limping after the play, number 22, the other starting corner.
Well, they're going to get Scandrick off the field and get right back to playing. Quentin Jones has come in on the far side along with Austin Smith, as you mentioned, Charles. There's Smith, number 37. Will they come after him? The answer is yes.
He's playing a soft corner, giving a lot of cushion He gave about a 12-yard cushion right there. Just an easy throw and catch.
Remember, Quentin Jones was the starter when the season began, but lost his job to Kyle Wilson. Austin Smith hasn't been the starter, but I will tell you this, in practice the other day, when they were in pads, he hit Ian Johnson on a running play, almost started a little bit of a dispute between Ian and himself.
Like Chris Petersen was after him.
2:06 to go.
I would find him in coverage, though, and try and work him.
He's rolled up. He's playing tight coverage. Got a little help over the top.
Ball at the 39. Thompson across the middle. Iglesias inside the 30. Tiptoes out of bounds to the 22. 2 minutes remaining. That is a gain of 16. Thompson taking him right down the field. But remember, they need a touchdown and the two-point conversion.
Thompson showing a lot of composure, seeing the field. Now, that Boise front has to be tired. This is where you tire out a defensive front. No huddle. Hurry to the ball.
I thought you said they were awfully fresh. I mean, when did they get tired here? When did that happen?
The no huddle.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
No huddle. They're going to bring five. Looks like they're going to bring five.
Here's that big freshman tight end, Gresham. Haven't found him at all tonight.
Thompson breaks a tackle from Browning. Gets it down to the 15. Plenty of time here. There's a minute 50 to go. They're at the 15-yard line. They're out of timeouts, but they'll get up to the line of scrimmage.
And I say hurry. I mean, get off the ground. You got to get off the ground. Get your people lined up. Thompson makes his call.
See, Boise State just substituted in a defensive lineman trying to get some fresh legs. Ian Smart.
Thompson on the slant. And a flag comes in. And there's the man you talked about a moment ago. Lost his job as a starter earlier this season. Quentin Jones.
Listen, I don't know everything about football, but I remember a coach telling me a long time ago as we listed
pass interference, defense, number 23. Spot foul, automatic, first down.
Watch, he's gonna be hugged up on the receiver. Here's Jones getting there a little early, trying to get the play through the man to get to the ball. But that coach told me, if a guy comes into the game, you test him early, because otherwise he would have been on the field to begin with if he was as good as the guy who was out there. Check him out.
Jones is now off as they bring in an extra lineman up front for Boise State, figuring Oklahoma will throw. First and goal from the 5. A minute 30 to go. Oklahoma needing a touchdown and a two-point conversion to tie.
See how they're playing off? They won't retreat from that goal line.
To the end zone. Tipped. Caught by Cheney.
Wow.
Touchdown, Oklahoma. Now they have to go and get two. They have tried two-point conversion this season, and it failed.
Tell you, it's very difficult to find a hole as you drop that many people in that short a distance. The field is restricted, but he squeezed that in there. Excellent vision. It's a tip drill.
And this
the
time,
ball's tipped.
And this time the receiver won the tip drill.
Well, look at Chris Petersen egging his team on. A Sooner fan.
Oh, this is tough.
Can't
Sooners,
stand to watch.
Sooners having trouble with personnel.
Running.
Trying to get the right personnel in the ball game, and they don't have a timeout to spend right now. The second guy has run off the field again. Now they have their guys. I have to use Paul Thompson and his legs to challenge the corner run pass option.
Thompson, jump ball to the corner, and a flag comes down on Scandrick, who's back in the game. He got tied up with Cheney.
Ball now, guys, if it's interference, his ball's got to go down to the 1.5, right? Or does it go to the 1? Normally it's the 2 when the ball's out in the field, but it's
pass interference,
conversion.
Defense number 8. We're still on the try.
Half the distance.
So it's half the distance, ball's on the 1 yard line.
It's a good call.
So that's a little
good call.
Half and a little bit more. Now, do you come back inside and hand it off to the horse? Or do you still, see, to me, I'm still trying to run pass option with my quarterback. I want extra options.
Coach, what are you doing?
I got to go run pass option. Give the quarterback the chance.
3 tight end set. Adrian Petersen in the eye. Gresham on the jump ball to the end zone. Did he get it? There's a flag down. Still no signal given by the official. There is a flag on the play.
It's going to be interesting because Gresham was the motion man over there, splitting wide. They tried to use him to isolate by formation, a mismatch, which they did. Let's see what the flag is, though.
Was he not set, Charles?
Could be. Could be.
Illegal shift. Offense. Two men moving without reset. 5-yard penalty. Still on the try.
The call.
Holy mackerel.
The call was excellent. Watch. Gresham. There's the motion by Finley, and there goes the motion by Gresham 18. 19 and 18, the two tight ends in motion. I love the call in terms of isolating him on the linebacker, but now they've got a big one.
Schleckaway comes racing off the field. They put in an extra defensive back. The ball now spotted at the 7-yard line. This is the game.
This is it. Still say they've got to get Thompson out of the pocket where he's on the move.
Pump fake. Thompson to the end zone. Catch is made, and we're tied at 28 by Joaquin Iglesias. What an unbelievable drive led by the senior Paul Thompson.
They try to throw another fade, but good awareness by Thompson and patience to find open receiver.
The numbers of Paul Thompson on this drive, guys. 5 for 5, 66 yards. Reminds you of the 99-yard drive against Nebraska in the Big 12 title game, where he was 6 of 8. On that drive and led them downfield for a touchdown.
Well, when they were down by 18, both of you guys said, in our amount of time this week with Bob Stoops and the Oklahoma staff, character, the number one word repeated over and over and over again about Paul Thompson.
Well, we said it earlier, but this is about expectations. Oklahoma expects to win. No one panicked on the drive. You saw Thompson, who's been struggling during the day. He's had some issues, takes him straight down the field. No, everyone kept their composure, made plays when they had to, overcame a penalty.
I know one thing. You and I are both fired as play callers because we kept calling that run-pass option, and they wanted to stay in the pocket, and it worked for them. But watch, coaches, you called it. He wanted to throw a fade here because what they ran was Cheney on a slant and then going to the fade. He had to come to his second option, which was Joaquin Iglesias in the middle.
Since 1999, these are the two winningest programs in all of college football. The senior quarterback who went the circuitous route to get that starting job back, Paul Thompson, has done his part. Now can a three-year starter, a 32-5 record as a starter, Jared Zabransky, can he get his team down the field to win it?
Look at the catch by Iglesias going down to secure the catch and making sure that he had his arms underneath it. I think they're taking a look at it, but in my estimation,
no,
that's a good catch.
They're ready to kick this thing off. So here we go. 1:26 to play. Boise has two timeouts. And that ball, 3 yards deep into the end zone, and this is Quentin Jones to bring it out. Out across the 20 to the 25. Tonight's All-State good hands play of the game. You just saw it. On their third try for the two-point conversion after a couple of penalties. Finding Iglesias, who's had a monster night, over 100 yards receiving, 120 to be exact.
And they got it three times they had to go, and the odds of getting a two-point conversion are well below 50%. And they had to do it three times and convert it.
Clock is running. They've set the ball, and Zabransky, a dangerous throw, and it's intercepted into the end zone, Marcus Walker.
Unbelievable.
Well, the big dog got hungry.
Let's take a look at it.
Zabransky, I guess, expecting, what, Charles, a receiver to Break to the sideline.
He thought he was going to the sideline, and he threw the ball on a timing route without really seeing the break of the defensive back. The receiver continues upfield. Does Walker stay in bounds is the question right now. Boise State praying that he did not, but it appears that the tightrope walking of Marcus Walker is going to pay off for Oklahoma.
Walker took over as a starter at cornerback the fourth game of the season. Last year had a pair of surgeries, one on each shoulder. Played only seven games.
Can we all agree coming into this game, one of the questions was, would Jared Zabransky play within himself, not make the crucial mistakes that we saw him make at Georgia to open the 2005 season? Up into that throw. So the play's upheld. Touchdown. So up until that throw, he had about one other bad one with the sack. But overall, what a heartbreaker for that senior.
Well, you question him, his thought from throwing one hash, an out cut. Regardless of whether the receiver made the proper cut or not, or ran the proper route, he's throwing from a far hash mark, an out cut on the other boundary. That's a lot of exposure.
Game's not over yet. There's still a minute two remaining. Boise State has two timeouts left, down by seven. We invite you to stay tuned here on Fox after the game for the DirecTV postgame show. Chris Rose, Jimmy Johnson, Barry Switzer, and company standing by. We'll have the trophy presentation on the field. 28-10. Boise State led it at the 8:05 mark of the third quarter. Oklahoma, 25 unanswered points since then.
You know, an expression comes to mind that may seem somewhat trite at this moment, but after you quoted all those stats, Tom, for Oklahoma, been there, done that. And here they are.
You know, the last kickoff, I thought that thing might come out.
Yeah.
It was blocked pretty well.
He was close. He was about one guy from popping it.
The ball's being kicked about 1 yard. If he can get another yard, they take a knee.
If you're Oklahoma, you have to cover all the way through, because I don't think the young man back there, Quentin Jones, has much of a mind to put a knee down in the end zone.
No.
Jones, 2 yards deep, will bring it out again. He's out to the 22-yard line. We have 54 seconds, but again, a reminder, once they set the ball, the play clock will start, so Boise State needs to get out onto the field.
And over the ball.
Once the official sets the chains, you'll see him crank it. Here goes the clock. New rule.
And Tom, you brought up a great point. This isn't over. Jared Zabransky actually gets a chance for redemption on this last drive. Still good to have a senior pulling the trigger for you.
Clock running at 50 seconds. Zabransky steps up, looking down the field, fires, and it's caught by the tight end Schumann, trying to get out of bounds. He's to the 43.
Clock stops, though. It's a first down. So hustle up and get on the line of scrimmage. They can spike the ball if they so choose here.
It's a gain of 36. They do have two timeouts left. Zabransky has them ready.
They're showing a lot of poise in this situation too, aren't they?
Zabransky, down he goes into the arms of Larry Burdine, and they're going to have to call a timeout. Loss of 8. 30 seconds remain. Well, certainly three of the plays you look at in this game. The touchdown catch, the two-point conversion, then the next offensive play from scrimmage, the interception by Walker, who races into the end zone, giving Oklahoma its first lead of the game.
And how about that play by Marcus Walker? Let me take you back a couple of years. They took a red shirt off of him late in the season, the 2004 season, because they were struggling at corner. He really helped save their year as a true freshman. Comes back his sophomore year, injured, beat up, as you articulated, Tom, two shoulder surgeries. He didn't play all that well. Came back this year with a vengeance, his second team all Big 12, and caps it off with that interception.
So 30 seconds remain. What's Bob Stoops saying to his defense over there, Charles?
I think what he's saying right now is we're going to play it a little bit looser to make sure we don't give up anything behind us, but at the same time, not so loose that we make it easy. I think they're still going to try and put pressure on Zabransky.
He's playing a quarter, four deep, each responsible for
one quarter of the field. Almost like the old Tom Landry umbrella defense.
Three rushes.
Second down and 18. Zabransky fires, and it is caught down at the 29. No, it came loose. It looked like James had it. And then it came squirting out of there. Boy, Zabransky thought he had it as well.
Lendy Holmes, number 11, the corner, had retreated all the way back so that he was underneath. And then Darian Williams, number 41, actually breaks up the pass with a hit on Drizin James, number 11.
Oklahoma's trying to get some type of pressure with three, dropping everyone deep. You're four deep, or getting as deep as they can.
Wonder if they're going to bring a
lot of underneath help.
Wonder if they'll end up bringing a fourth, showing a three look.
Schumann racing on the field before the snap of the football. Zabransky fires into traffic and running a flag is Rab on Darian Williams, none thrown. Fourth down and 18 upcoming for Boise State.
So you've got your underneath linebackers dropping. They're 20 yards deep. You've got your quarters players, each your secondary players. They're deeper. Nobody's going to get behind them.
No one's going to get behind, and you're trying to flood the zones to make it tougher for those receivers to find gaps.
They need to get to the Oklahoma 32 to move the chains. A last gasp for the Broncos.
Bransky's legs might be critical here to save time on throwing the ball.
Down the middle, James, the lateral to the corner of the end zone. Can you believe that?
I've seen it all. Now,
the catch by James, the lateral, and that's a design play to Gerard Rab, who races into the end zone. And now the point after to try and tie it in the final seconds. A fourth down and 18. Anthony Montgomery, and it is good. Well, it's not the size of the dog in the fight. It's the size of the fight in the dog.
And how about Jared Zabransky and his redemption after the interception, the hook and lateral, and it goes in. This is beautiful. Shades of Utah, Fiesta Bowl, yep. 2004.
Boy, is that, look at the execution.
It's perfect. And look at Lewis Baker ran right by him because he wasn't expecting that at all. And Rab beats him to the corner.
Boy, it doesn't get much better than that right there.
Listen, our colleague Jimmy Johnson working the show with us. How about those Broncos?
Unbelievable. Absolutely unbelievable. A fourth and 18. Charles, you said no trickery, no razzle-dazzle.
Until now.
But the old cliche about, you know, desperate times and desperate measures.
Call it desperate measures.
Fourth and 18, and Chris Petersen says, that's how we do it on the blue field in Boise every day during practice.
We don't care if it's blue, green, wherever. This team is never flinched. Nope.
All right, line drive kick. This will be the final play of regulation. And boys and girls, we are on our way to overtime in the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl. 78 yards, five plays, a fourth and 18. They score in 55 seconds. Welcome to the BCS Bowl Bash on Fox.
And that's against a good defense.
All right, overtime rules. Each team given one possession from the opposition's 25. The leader after those possessions, it's not a sudden death here, each team gets a shot, is the winner. If the teams are tied, the process takes place and do it all over again until one team leads at the end of possessions. Make sure you understand that now. And after the second OT, teams must attempt a two-point conversion.
Right, and the kicking game goes out of it at that point. One other thing to keep in mind, you can score on defense. So if you are on defense first, most teams, when they win the toss, they choose to go on defense so they know what they have to match
right.
as you go along. But if you score on defense first, that's game over because you don't need an offensive possession then.
You can even see the respect the players have for one another as the captains come out for this coin toss.
Boise, you'll call a toss. The winner of the toss has the option to go on offense, defense, or one end of the field. We'll play that inning at the same end. Your choice?
Tails.
Tails, that's the blue side. It's come up tails. Boise, you've won the toss. You'll play defense first.
All righty, Oklahoma will get it in the overtime. Here we go.
That's what I'm talking about. Hey, that doesn't work. That never used to happen.
We can't lose if they can't stop us, baby. Okay? We can go all day. We can go all day. Huh? Let's go, baby.
The emotion, the spirit of college football.
Let's see who can rally now. They've banged heads, they've gone at it, we've seen about everything. Now you come down to overtime.
Yeah, the tough one for Oklahoma is they thought this thing was over.
Yep.
They thought it was done. Now they have to come back and continue to battle with a team that they thought they had finally put away. And Boise State says, we're not going anywhere.
Adrian Peterson in the backfield. Overtime is underway and Peterson with the football. Off to the left side, down the sideline. Leaps, did he get in or step out of bounds? Touchdown, Adrian Peterson. That did not take long.
Where was more of that stretch play earlier in the ball game with Adrian Peterson?
I like him running that stretch play.
I like him running anything.
Boy, that was blocked very well.
It was.
Blocked very well, but I tell you what, he's got a burst. He gets to that corner. There's a seam, and he can get it.
Left side. Great hole.
Inside, outside.
Inside, outside. You had 72, Robinson, 79, Mesmer. And then Cooper, number 50. And then look downfield. Nice block by Iglesias, number 9. And number 84, Cheney occupied enough of the DB to get into the end zone.
Big point after. And it is good. Off the foot of Garrett Hartley. So one play, a 25-yard touchdown run by Adrian Peterson in overtime. His father celebrating. Can Boise answer? Coach took over for Dan Hawkins, of course, who assumed the head coaching duties at the University of Colorado. 5 years as offensive coordinator under Coach Hawkins. Chris Petersen, his team down 7 in overtime.
Benny
Peretta thought about throwing the football. He gets back to the line of scrimmage.
He was going to throw that back to the quarterback. He showed it, you have to tuck that ball, give a good run fake first. Well defended by Oklahoma. They recognized
it. And the throw back to the quarterback, I don't think was going to end the sequence. I think it was going to come back to Zabransky, who was going to throw it back downfield.
Ian Johnson standing on the sideline. Second down and 10. Rolls Zabransky out, comes back the other way to the tight end, Schumann. Got a couple of good blocks. But at the end of the day, it's only a gain of 2. Third down upcoming.
Boise's got to
their thought process now, let's get a first down. If you have two shots, let's get a first down.
And if I'm Brett Venables, I'm thinking not blitzing here. First two plays, he has not blitzed. He's trying to keep everything in front of him now. If he had blitzed on that play, I think that tight end screen works a lot better. So in this situation, you might think about not coming after Zabransky and making him earn it.
Third down and 7.
Short drop, Zabransky to Schumann. And he bangs his way inside the 15, good enough for a first down. Ran right into Zach Latimer.
Yeah, I love what Derek Schumann gives them as the tight end. There he is, number 91. He's going to come right into this zone in the middle and find the dead zone and then turn his shoulders. And, Coach, you talked earlier about being shoulder to shoulder, not turning so the guy can't split you. Schumann, the tight end, split the defenders that time for the first down.
It's a well-designed play. Clear the zone out, bring him underneath.
Ball to the 13-yard line. First down, Boise State trailing by 7 in the first overtime. Hand off to Peretta.
He should be down back there unless his knee did not hit. I saw the referee coming in. I thought he was coming in to mark him down when he slid, taking the handoff.
No, they haven't been quote-unquote cute the entire game until now, this overtime. Now.
And the last play of the game, it carries over into overtime. We're seeing the whole playbook emptied by Boise State. See, I thought Peretta's knee had gone down on the handoff, and no one's challenging it, so it must not have.
Second down and 8 for the Broncos at the Oklahoma 11. They're going to hand it off to Ian Johnson. Still on his feet, close to a first down, inside the 5 to the 4, needed to get to about the 3.5. Like he's about a foot short.
And remember, they have to match with a touchdown. Watch Ian Johnson. We talked about his patience and his toughness all night long. See how he reads it? It's one of the things the Oklahoma coaches told us about him, is that he knows how to read blocks and read angles in the defenses, and that run put him over 100 yards for the evening.
Third down and less than a yard. Johnson denied the first down. Is the ball loose or was his knee down? I think they're saying he was down. They are saying, I believe, he was down at the 5.5-6 yard line.
Ball being marked. Now we bring up a fourth down. Let's take a look at the play as Ian Johnson tries to run it inside. There's the initial hit as he's knocked back and he's stumbling, going. Ball came out before he went down.
I think his knee was down.
You thought it was down back there?
I think
there?
His knee's down first.
Let's take
right,
a look. Look,
right
look,
here.
Look, right there. Good call, Coach.
Yep. All right, here we go again. Now a timeout is called by Boise State. Much like the 4th and 18 in regulation. Down to one play. They got the touchdown on the razzle-dazzle. Now it's 4th and 2 in overtime. Well, the bowl bash on Fox continues tomorrow night. Louisville and Wake Forest. What great seasons they've had. Surprise seasons. In the FedEx Orange Bowl, it all gets underway at 7:30 Eastern, 4:30 Pacific, and high def only on Fox. They're still reviewing this last play. Did Johnson's knee hit the ground? And they've just told us the decision on the field stands. So 4th and 2 upcoming for the Broncos.
Let's see if they can answer again.
See, right there, ball is still in his hand. Now as he's going down, it's an excellent call. Coach Alvarez had spotted it. Against San Jose State, they needed a 2-point conversion to get it done in a touchdown. They used Jared Zabransky using his legs, sprinting to the corner with a run-pass option, and he delivered the pass.
Is Ian Johnson out of the game?
Catching balls is not his forte. Vinny Peretta is a converted wide receiver in the backfield.
And he's behind center. And the quarterback, Zabransky, is in motion.
They run it.
They do this a lot. Peretta to take the snap. He's going to throw it to the end zone. Touchdown!
Yeah, They're going to go for two, guys. I'm telling you, they are tired. Listen, when you're Cinderella, at a certain point, you don't keep slugging with the big guy. They're going to try and win the football game right now. That's what I'm telling you.
Yep. Well, you know Oklahoma will spend a timeout. This is the touchdown. Well, you talk about guts as a play call.
I'm telling you. Run pass option. Well, is Vinny Peretta doing it this time?
Well, you see Peretta. That's my, I'm thinking as a defensive player, I see Peretta there. What's he done?
Well, here we go, fellas. What are you going to do now? Going for the win.
Zabransky, flood right. Ball's near the left half. Flood right.
Going to get a timeout by Oklahoma.
All right, now do you change your mind if you're Chris Petersen and send out the extra point?
He has a play he wants to call. He has the play. Oklahoma doesn't know what they're going to line up in offensively because they're going to shift anyhow. They showed that they have three wides, but where were they going to end up? They're going to give you some type of shift. They have the play call.
That was almost basketball where you show something, call timeout because you've seen something, and you come back with something different.
Fellas, you know what everybody across the country that's watching right now is saying? It's calls like this, it's effort like this, guts like this, which screams for a playoff in Division 1A football. Why not give Boise State the shot at Ohio State, the shot at Florida? This game tonight will further the cries of the underdogs of the world wanting a national championship playoff format.
And you know something else, Tom? The counter to that would be the president saying, is this one outstanding football game or not? What more do we need?
Well, they're also presidents of Division I AA schools and Division II and Division III.
Hey,
presidents vote to have a playoff.
I'm not arguing that point, but they're not running this game.
Boise State had their shot at Oklahoma, and they're giving them a heck of a shot.
Guys, I still
think... They don't need to worry about anything else right now. Let's take a look at this.
Zabransky, I still think him with some type of run-pass option going to the right.
Boise State for the win. They hand it off to Johnson. Boise State has won the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl. Can you believe it? It doesn't get much better than that.
They run on a Statue of Liberty play.
Earlier in the season, they ran that look, and they threw a quick screen out of that formation, and this was the counter to it. They knew it was on tape. Oklahoma seen it. They threw it out there to Nene, and this time they fake it and hand it off the old Statue of Liberty, and no one better than Ian Johnson with the year he's had. Now, that football was supposed to go in the trophy case, but someone else has got it now.
Again, Charles, let's go back to coaching here. He knows that Oklahoma has studied every film they have.
That's it.
They know every two-point conversion. They're going to defend. Bobby Stoops' team's coached well enough. They're going to defend what they saw. They come back with the counter.
He knew it was on tape, and they threw the counter at them. But the number one thing, and we talked about it in the break, and I said it to you, Tom, they would go for two there, wouldn't they?
Let's go downstairs to Chris Myers.
We're just getting a hug, Zabransky, from the opposing quarterback, Paul Thompson from the Sooners. Congratulations on one of the greatest college football games we've ever seen.
Oh, it's unbelievable. You know, these guys just kept believing and kept believing, and that shows where they got it. We got it right here. We just kept battling from that last play of regulation all the way to that play. It's unbelievable.
Biggest win in the history of Boise State football. What about that final play, the fake, without hesitation to go for two?
I mean, we wanted to come out here and win. We weren't going to hold anything back. We've been practicing that play, you know, all season long. We put that in. Actually, our backup quarterback put that extra fake in. And it was just, when it worked out, we ran it against Idaho, and it was good. And we just held on to it until now.
You threw an interception that looked like it would cost you the game. Did that cross your mind? How did you get over that?
Well, you know what? It's not over until it's 0-0-0. And I knew that. And the guys came up to me and they said they believed in me.
That's all I needed.
Perfect season. Do you deserve a shot at Ohio State?
I think we do. I think you got to look at it. You know, we go 13-0. We beat everybody on our schedule. Now, the media talks about Oklahoma being such a great team, and they battled, but we let them come back into it. And you know what? We deserve a chance at a national title.
All right, here's your congratulations.
Thank you.
Jared Zabransky. All the chips are on the table. The Tostitos Fiesta Bowl champions, Tom.
The people of Idaho, the school, the other mid-majors, non-BCS conferences, celebrate tonight. DirecTV postgame coming up.